Released at noon due to the impending blizzard in New York, the trial is set to continue on Thursday. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports travel bans and early school closings were announced Monday as the Northeast prepared for a coastal storm bringing blizzard-like conditions. While much of the area got some combination of rain, snow, freezing rain, and sleet, conditions are expected to get dramatically worse. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo announced all trains and buses will be shut down and all driving will be banned in 13 affected counties. The travel ban began at 11 p.m. Monday night. At a press conference Monday afternoon, Cuomo said, "This is a serious situation. If you violate this state order, it's a possible misdemeanor. It's fine up to $300. Additionally, flights are being canceled nationwide because of the impending storm. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Now, a lot of little girls do ballet even though their fathers couldn't care less and don't see what the big deal is. But one talented little prodigy actually choreographed a whole ballet that her father could enjoy and even look forward to. Let's meet Erin Kemper and her father, Jack.
Hi.
Thanks for having us.
Erin, how did you do that?
I thought about all the things that my dad likes to watch and put it into a ballet.
Well, we have a special treat for you today because Erin is now going to perform her new ballet. When I pay the bills, I get to make the rules.
We can't afford that. World War II. I miss your mother too, but we're gonna have to do the best without her. Go Redskins!
Bravo! Well done. Boy, I wish you were mine. You know, my two girls are grown up, but you still couldn't pay me to watch one of their a cappella shows. What inspired you to create this amazing ballet?
I'm really inspired by the theme of my dad paying any attention to me at all.
Now, at the end, I hear she just put the game up on the big screen.
I don't know where she gets it.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves. 855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number, 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online over at freetalklive.com. We have a lot of features on the website. A lot of those talk show hosts charge you for their sites. Ours is free. So go and enjoy freetalklive.com. Last night, Mark, we teased a story that you wanted to talk about with a mother engaging in what is called fat shaming. And to me, this doesn't really seem like news. I'm not sure, you know, what's the issue here. I mean, have you experienced this? What made you want to bring this to the table? I don't know anything about it.
Fat shaming's a thing, right? I mean, you know, it's become a thing.
People have been picking on folks for their body types, whether it's being too fat or too skinny or...
For as long as there have been body types and been people, right?
Wearing glasses. I mean, I remember elementary school. So what you're saying is this woman's an adult and she's fat shaming.
Well, I'm not claiming that she's fat shaming. I'm claiming that she's being accused of fat shaming.
Aha. All right. So, well, I've heard nothing on this, so let's do it.
I gotcha. So the gal's name is Abby Pell, and... This is coming from, there's all kinds of stories on this, but the one I've got here is from Fox8.com. Funny or fat shaming? Mom faces backlash over six-pack abs and Instagram photo. So Abby Pell she's from England, West Sussex, if you know your England. But I don't have no clue where the lady's from. But she is definitely a hot mom.
Okay.
Right? Like, she is as fit as they come. She likes to take pictures on her and put them on her Instagram of her in her underpants. And this is her thing, right? Like, and
good for her.
Right. She's got every business taking pictures of herself in her underpants, too. And her husband, ripped as he could possibly be.
This lady's like a supermodel or something. She's pretty good looking.
Yeah, she's probably a little short for a supermodel, but you know, I mean, nonetheless, she's put the time in, she's put the hard work in, and she's got the body to prove it.
Okay.
And she's gotten some trouble, and that trouble just continues to sort of simmer. Actually, this one of these posts, she's kind of calmed down since then, but she put a post here that of her holding up her shirt. you actually, I don't think, on this photo, you can't see her face entirely, but you can see her daughter, who's kind of like got that, oh my, look, while she's looking at the camera and she's pointing at her mommy's abs.
Okay.
And she's saying, I have a kid, a six pack, and no excuse. So this is, the claim
is. This is what she's posting on her own Twitter or Instagram?
Yeah, her social media.
Okay.
And, you know, she's got a certain amount of followers because, well, it's easy to put up a picture of a pretty lady and get a bunch of followers,
no doubt,
at least on Facebook. I'm not familiar with Instagram, really, but I suspect that the it holds true.
So what you're saying is she's made a comment about herself on her own social media.
That's correct.
Has there been an allegation that this lady has gone on the pages of overweight people and actually shamed them in their own domain?
This is the hypersensitivity to which I am trying to refer here.
Okay.
This is a lady who's, you know, when I would work out, I would often have sort of a rough way of sort of speaking to myself. Come on, Mark, burn that grease. You know, things like that, that would
fight more,
motivate me to do things. Yeah. And she has this kind of sound here, but you know, some people just can't. Some people who apparently can't get their butt in the gym and do some crunches or whatever, you know, it's just a little too much for them when she says she doesn't have an excuse. And the claim is that she's pressuring mums to that's England, to. You know, like, it's already, life's hard enough for us women, and you come out here with a six-pack abs. it's kind of the complaint. And I'm not going to claim life isn't hard for women. I would contend that, you know, my wife, I don't know, with one kid, how she gets done the things she needs to get done. It seems like she's constantly working. But, you know, and she doesn't have a 9-to-5 job. And so I can understand why women feel pressured. I hope they understand that men feel pressured. But I don't
really. Yeah, I don't always feel that great when a guy with six-pack abs shows up.
Right, that jerk walking around with those six-pack abs.
But at least I recognize that that's my problem, not his.
Right. So that's kind of what's going on here. This poor lady has worked out very hard and, you know, gotten a great body to show for it. And people her, what I would say is shaming her for her hard work.
Mm.
And it's
jealous.
Back and forth. That's what it seems like to me. Now, she claims that she's trying to inspire people, which I'm sure she is. I've been accused of, I don't know my English accents for my West Sussex, but I've been accused of adding unnecessary pressure on women, and more specifically to mums, to lose weight.
You sound more like a Catholic schoolmarm or something like that.
She says, I'd like to clarify that it is not my objective whatsoever. So, she's
good
trying.
Lord, I hope she doesn't sound like that.
Well, it would help make up for having the six-pack abs, maybe. If she sounds
to
like that, people
out.
Won't be so jealous.
Yeah.
She says, this is not quoted, she says, I don't live in the gym, and I don't eat nothing but rabbit food. I do have a ton of other time-consuming commitments and days that stress me out. I crave chocolate and wine, and sometimes I would rather spend my evenings sat on the sofa eating hobnobs and watching TV. I can't tell you how many evenings I've sat on the sofa eating hobnobs.
Is a hobnob like a bonbon?
I have no clue.
Okay.
Watching TV and sweating my butt off at the gym. But I make time for exercise and I make healthy choices when it comes to what I eat. It's about priorities, and I don't regret the choices I've made. It's not easy, but it's a lot easier than looking in the mirror every day and not feeling happy with the reflection staring back at you.
Hobnobs are a brand name of a commercial biscuit, which, of course, is another word for cookie over in the UK. Inspired by a traditional recipe, they're made from rolled oats and jumbo oats, similar to a flapjack/digestive biscuit hybrid. Now you know more about a hobnob.
That sounds
awful. I don't
know
what a flapjack digested biscuit is, but okay.
An oat cookie.
It's an oat cookie. So anyway, she says, be happy, be healthy, and empower others to feel the same.
That sounds fine.
It's all fine. This is a bunch of ridiculous crap by jealous people who are transposing their feelings upon this lady.
No, maybe I missed it. Who's writing about this? Where are you?
It's all over.
I've not seen it.
Go look, get on your favorite search engine and search Abby Pell, and you will find myriad stories on this woman. I mean, it's just over and over again.
Well, where's this one coming from? What is this?
This is Fox8.com.
Was there some particular celebrity do-gooder who called this person out? Or
I haven't gotten that. I think it's just the kerfuffle over it. And I understand that women often feel pressured, and that much I get, and I think that that's a legitimate concern. But what they're probably not understanding is many of Abby's choices have to do with diet and not exercise. She certainly goes and exercises, but we all have enough time to exercise if you have enough time for entertainment, right? Mm-hmm. Like, sure. If you're watching TV, or playing games, you have time for exercise. What her choices are largely dietary choices that give her the body that she's got. And most of us choose not to make the dietary choices that she chooses to make. This lady is eating a lot of vegetables. She is eating chicken breast with nothing on it. These are the dietary choices that she chooses to make. If you want to eat more fatty foods and more carbs and then all that stuff, you're not going to have the body that Abby has, and all the complaining in the world isn't going to change it.
I would love to hear from somebody who thinks this lady's done something wrong here, because it seems pretty clear to me. I haven't read any
I haven't found
posts.
Anything that she's done wrong.
So you've reviewed her posts?
I've looked over and over. Now, this lady has this concern has been going on for more than a year.
Over her posts.
Over her posts. And she has these kind of, rah, rah, let's go posts. All right, troops, get it in line. Let's get out there and work out.
She's like a fitness blogger what I'm seeing here. That's what you expect from a fitness blogger.
The bizarre thing is, what makes her enough of a public figure that anybody's concerned with what she's
posting?
Everybody's
a public figure now.
I guess. I mean, usually you'd think somebody would be a celebrity before there's controversy over their Twitter post.
Well, there are. Within the fitness world, there are people who are known within that world, but maybe you and I wouldn't know about them.
Their equivalent.
855-450 free. We'll talk about it coming up here. It's Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Thank you.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. One mom has been posting pictures of herself online, and she's apparently a fitness blogger. She, you know, posts about the stuff she's eating, her workouts. She shows the results, and she's gotten some really good results. She's a good-looking lady, and as she pointed out, she's had a kid, and she's got rock-hard abs, and she says no excuses on one of her pictures, just one of her myriad of photos on her Instagram account of herself modeling and, you know, looking very, very nice. And apparently there are a number of people who are very upset at this lady for daring to actually say things like have a kid, six-pack, and no excuse. And this is apparently upsetting a number of people who claim she's what's called fat-shaming. But to me, I don't see anything. I'm looking at her her posts here, and I don't know where the blogging actually happens, because Instagram is not a blog site. It's just a place where people post pictures. But she's being called a fitness blogger, so maybe she actually has a blog somewhere. And maybe she does engage in fat shaming, but so far I haven't seen that. What I've seen is a lady just trying to kind of motivate people who are paying attention to her.
It sounds more like skinny bragging than fat shaming.
Yeah, I'd say it's that.
And fine, good for her. I mean, she's got...
What's the line on that?
Well, somebody's got to toot your horn. I mean, there's nothing wrong with tooting your own horn, because you're probably the only one who's going to, right? So,
yep.
Well, I guess the other question is, what's the significance of crossing that line?
I mean,
okay, so if somebody decides to say that fat people should be less fat, well, they have that right.
Yeah, I think
that's... And other people have the right to say, well, screw you, I'm happy the way I am.
Indeed, and I kind of wonder, because generally what society is going to provide to you is they're going to provide to you a list of more and less optimal behaviors, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's kind of the definition of a society or a culture. And do we want to add being obese to the list of preferred or acceptable behaviors? It's not like I'm not moving that direction myself. I need to lose weight as much as anybody, but I'm just kind of, it's a pressure, right? Like, that's a societal pressure. And what is it that we want to provide to people? Because it seems like you're not supposed to have an opinion on anything about anybody else, right?
So there's another picture here on her Instagram that says, "Do you even lift?" which is something that I've seen before. Yeah. It's another kind of meme, and it shows her standing in a gym. She's got a barbell with two fairly large-looking weights on the side. Now, you can't tell if there's somebody else on the other side holding it up for her.
The lady, I've seen the lady doing pull-ups. She's strong.
Yeah. So, I mean, presumably this is her actually holding this thing up, and it says, "Do you even lift?" Now, that could be interpreted as her shaming, you know, skinny, wimpy guys like me. I mean, so she's not... I don't think she's necessarily even attacking fat people here. It's just a shot at people who, you know, don't work out.
I don't even think it's that. I mean, I think it's encouragement, really. I don't even I don't take what she says as a shot, right?
Well, do you even lift is definitely, like, when you deliver it's that to
right,
somebody.
It's saying you.
If you're not delivering it to any particular person, do you even lift? Does who even lift?
That's true. She's not delivering it to any particular person. But the classic use from what I've seen of this, like Vitaly is one of these YouTube pranksters. He goes around to guys who are actually look kind of buff, and then he'll say something like, "Do you even lift?" And, you know, it's not particularly one of his best videos, but that's the way it's delivered. Like, you know, delivering that to somebody to kind of insult their physical prowess, I guess you could say. But so what? It's her Instagram. If she wants to put whatever she wants on her Instagram, who cares? If you don't like the lady's attitude, don't read her Instagram. This is like the same thing that happens when sometimes I'll post something on my Facebook page, and I don't even know. I can't give you an example of what it might be, but it's something that could offend, right? Like somebody might get upset about what I've posted. And then people get upset about it, and, you know...
You'll say things about people that have not yet moved to New Hampshire who believe in the ideas of liberty. Like, I've seen that be a problem for you.
Oh, yeah, like move to New Hampshire or something like that, sure. Yeah. And then people will get all upset about it. And, you know, my response to that is, if you don't like what I write, then please feel free to stop reading it anytime. You don't have to spend your time on my page.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like this is the same thing.
If you find me offensive, stop finding me.
Exactly.
And I guess, you know, the other concern I would have on this is, you know, what is fat shaming? Why is it, you know, why is it important? Because, I mean, what I would want to provide myself is both positive and negative reinforcement about my weight, right? Like, I want both of those things for me. So it's kind of a the do unto others thing, the golden rule. Like, I suspect she feels the same, right? Like, she's providing herself motivation, and some days it's the positive motivation, and some days it's the negative motivation that gets her to do whatever it is that she does. And she wants to provide both the positive and the negative motivation to people to get out there and do the things she's done, because she considers that to be a good thing. She considers that to be a value. And I would say that she's right. It is a value. If we consider, you know, I mean, all you have to do is look at the traffic that fit, you know, gals that work out get versus your average lard butt, and you'll see that the traffic is significantly higher for the, you know, the fit gals, and that they're able to get jobs and sponsorships and all kinds of things out of it. And, you know, look at me, I can eat a bag of Cheetos by myself, not sponsorable. And, you know, I mean, I think that this is, I think you should treat everybody with love and respect. But I think at the same time that we can provide both positive and negative reinforcement to people to, you know, be healthy and exercise.
So there you go.
A variety of things.
Her name is Abby, what was it, Pell?
Pell.
Abby Pell, spelled like it sounds. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We've got Erod in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything. Hello, Erod.
Yeah, hi, guys. Hey, I hate to switch reels on you, but it is Free Talk Live.
It is. Go ahead.
Yeah, but anyway, I have a story which is extremely disturbing that deserves, I believe, in my opinion, you know, national attention. A couple of years ago, back in 2013, you may have heard of a high school kid in Valdosta, Georgia. His name was Kendrick Johnson. He was found dead and rolled up in one of these gym
mats.
Right. You
oh,
heard
no.
of the story. Yeah. So at any rate, you know, there's been really hardly any movement on the story. He was the coroner first, you know, said that he died of blunt force trauma. Meanwhile, the investigators, the police said, oh no, he went in there looking for his shoe, and you know, the whole story just really stunk of high hell. And then it was later found out that, you know, all of his internal major internal organs were removed from his body.
Whoa.
His fingernails were, you know, his fingernails were just completely removed. But anyway,
this is news to me. I didn't hear that part at all.
Is this official? Oh. Is this what the coroner is saying, or is this what somebody else is saying?
No. This is the coroner. This is a fact. This is verified fact. You can search engine this, and you can probably, you know, find it out. All of his internal organs were completely missing, and his body was stuffed with newspapers, okay?
Whoa. What's his name again?
Kendrick Johnson, okay?
Yeah, because I remember seeing it and kind of looking at the story and saying, oh, well, I guess people die in weird ways, and because it was weird.
No, sir. This story stunk of high hell. Not only that, you know, some of the video inside the gymnasium was doctored after their family attorneys got in there. They saw that, you know, the tapes were doctored. Okay, but here's
stand by, E-Rod. We'll let you tell the rest of the story here in a moment. 855 450 free. You can take control of the airwaves. More coming up. This is Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090. Call 1-800-467-5090.
When commercials come on, don't push the button. Instead, listen. Even if you don't sell things for a living, you're still selling in the various conversations and transactions that make up your busy day. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. So take a lesson from Madison Avenue. Often the fewer words, the more effective the message. Like Jiffy Lube, where you never need an appointment, or the Office Max ad that says, "You supply the ambition, we supply everything else." How about online ticket broker StubHub.com, the way in when it's sold out, or CyberCupidMatch.com's seductive, "Go ahead, it's okay to look." How cleverly and succinctly can you distill your message? For more tips, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write "worms" in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Who is playing dress up as a yes?
Superhero.
Ninja.
A border ninja.
See, that would be the problem. Somebody else would dress up like a pirate, and then there would be a war.
Yeah. Just the pirates duking it out.
Wait, well, what do the pirates have against ninjas?
Oh, ninjas and pirates are like matter and antimatter. They can't be together.
Okay.
I have a feeling the ninjas would just whoop it up on the pirates.
Man. Are you kidding? Pirates. Arr. Pirates, man.
Oh, the pirates do have cannons. They have the long-range attack ability, but once you get in close...
It's hard to be tougher than a pirate, though.
The pirates are certainly tough, but the agility I don't think is there.
Lose
they sit around on a
lose
ship
a hand,
day.
Lose a leg. You can still get 200 people to be afraid of you as you stomp around with half of your, you know, an eye patch, one hand, one leg. You stomp around half a person, and you're still commanding 200 people.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here to bring up anything that's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, we've got Skype. You can Skype into the program at username lrn.fm. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. We're going back to E-Rod. But first, want to tell you about ExpressCoin. It's the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, whether they be Bitcoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're also a licensed money services business, so they've jumped through all those hoops, so you don't have to worry about it. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or by making a deposit at a local credit union that has shared banking. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com, whether in the U.S. or Canada. It's ExpressCoin.com. Plus, you can now do it from your smartphone by downloading their app at ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency with no fee at all. That's a great deal. ExpressCoin.com. The coupon code is FTL. As we go back to E-Rod in Georgia, E-Rod, you're telling us about a young man who was found dead, apparently rolled up in a wrestling mat at a high school gym. His name, Kendrick Johnson.
Yes.
Is this from your area down there in Georgia?
Actually, it is south. It is closer to Florida than it is where I'm currently at. I'm in the Atlanta area.
Gotcha.
And Valdosta, Georgia is going south, you know, closer to Florida.
Okay.
So at any rate...
That's where they have the Wee Bear All Club that you see.
Oh, well, the Valdosta Onions are about. No, is that Vidalia? I'm not sure.
That's Vidalia.
But anyway, that's not it. Yeah. But anyway, continuing with the story. So
hold on. So just real quick here. You said this guy's body was found with newspaper stuffed inside it?
Yes.
I think you've missed...
No. He wasn't found with it. But after, you know, the coroner, you know, after the body was taken away and... and they were preparing the body for burial and all this kind of stuff. You know, apparently the parents hired another coroner or something like that. Anyway, so all of his internal organs were found missing, and it was stuffed with newspaper, okay, to fill him out, okay?
Yeah. Now, is that unusual?
You know what? There has been some discussion about that, and I've heard where sometimes they – I'm not really sure. I've heard about that before. But at any rate, nobody has any answers as to why his internal organs were removed, why his fingernails were peeled off completely. Nobody has any answers.
Now, just to clarify, are the fingernails being peeled off? Is that something that happened with the coroner, or was that body was found?
After the body was found, the body was taken away. The body was intact and full, but apparently this was after, you know, the body was taken away and the parents came in and, you know, they hired their own coroner or whatever it is. And this is what they found out, you know, I guess prior to burial, you know, how they discovered the body. After they were preparing the body to be buried, you know, that the body was, you know, was stuffed with newspaper.
What if they... took the fingernails off to sort of test them to see if there is the flesh or blood of anybody who might have attacked him underneath the fingernails.
Well, I don't know. All of them, though, you know, I mean, you know, and
well,
what
yeah,
about,
I mean, you don't want to miss one.
And it sounds like all the stuff that was removed from the body was removed and misplaced. So
yeah, well, you know, oftentimes I've heard, because I believe there was an interview, and I've heard from that oftentimes they do test, you know, you know, some of the internal organs and see whether or not, you know, drugs or whatever wasn't, you know, something like that. But, you know, they usually put it back. But none of it was put back. It was just filled up with newspapers. Mm. So, you know, what's that disturbing. All about? I don't know.
Let me read this quote from Wikipedia, because I've looked at this since you were talking about it. I think it's still a really strange case. But,
it gets stranger, yeah. But go ahead.
Okay, I'll hear that. Well, you go ahead and tell me the stranger part, and then I'll read the quote.
Well, the stranger part is that here you have a grieving parent, okay, who want to get answers. How did my son die? And yesterday, they took these people to court because they are on charges of misdemeanor account of obstruction of a government building. Because
right.
Here you have, they are grieving what happened to my son, and they cannot get any answers. And these bastards out there have the gall, the audacity, these unsympathetic, no compassion, and they took them to court. They were in court today facing misdemeanor charges of obstruction. Now, I'm asking, what sort of a bastard does something like that, like to add injury to insult to injury.
You're talking about what kind of person would charge them with misdemeanor obstruction?
Exactly.
Well, just about any cop. Any cop. Now, look, what they apparently did was blocked entrance to a courthouse. Isn't that correct?
Yes, they did. And that is, and technically, by the rule of law, yeah, okay, you violated the law. But what I'm saying is, though, they are showing no compassion.
Well, that's their job. I mean, I'm not excusing it. I'm not excusing what happened to them, but that's what the police do. I mean, to be fair to the police, according to the story here, they did give them the chance to remove themselves from the premises, and they did not. So it wasn't as though the police just came right up and arrested them, at least according to the story.
Right, exactly. But you know what? So damn what?
Well, how long are they supposed to...
Have a heart. Be a damn human.
Sure, but how long are they supposed to allow protesters to close down the courthouse?
You know what? These are the parents. These are the parents. I'm sorry. Under notes, this is really, really disturbing to me. It really is. And you know what? This is why, I mean, just yesterday, or was it today, I heard about some guy shooting up a couple of cops when they were being, I don't know, they just graduated or something. They shot him up. And then, of course, you have the story of the killdozer, the guy who just, you know, fashioned some bulldozer, ran into City Hall.
Oh, yeah.
And then you got the guy who flies an airplane into an IRS building. You know what? When you hear about these stories, you know, you got to wonder, what the hell did these people, what happened to them? What did these people do to them?
Yeah, what pushes somebody to the limit like that? And I agree with you. I mean, certainly... handcuffing yourself, or I don't know what they did. I think it said they linked arms or something like that. But you know, whether it was handcuffing themselves or whatever, but locking themselves to the front door of the courthouse is certainly preferable to destroying the courthouse. There's no doubt about that. But I mean, the argument here, and they're likely going to be found guilty. It's a jury trial, isn't that right?
It is a jury trial.
Yeah.
It's absolutely. A total waste of taxpayer dollars, you know, to have this jury trial over these grieving parents who don't know what the hell happened to their son.
I agree. I think going too far would have been the criminal charges. I'm not supporting the charges in this case. I think the police
could have dropped the charges if they wanted.
Right. The police could have removed the parents. They could have said, get out of here, or we'll, you know.
They could have sent a psychiatrist to talk to them and, you know, help them with grief counseling and a variety of things.
But at the same time, I mean, there is an argument to say that if you're blocking the doorway to a, you know, and I'm not calling the court a place of business, but it is a place where other people have been ordered to go by the threat of violence. Mm-hmm. So, you know, Rich Paul, you or I could have had a trial that day, and if we didn't show up, we would have been charged with contempt of court.
I doubt it if there's people chained across the door.
You'd be surprised, Mark. These people don't care. I think that's what Erod's point is they don't have compassion. If
exactly.
You don't, right, you know.
My point. Forget the law. Forget the law. Be a human being, for God's sake. Be a human being. These people are monsters. They're...
I share your concerns.
They're monsters. That's the point I'm trying to make.
You have made that...
And,
Irad, and I thank you for the call tonight. Thanks bringing that story to my attention. It does sound vaguely familiar, and anyway, we can talk more about it here in moments. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and you can share your thoughts here. I mean, that's like a classic example of disorderly conduct, basically blocking people from being able to get from point A to point B. That's why those statutes in a lot of cases were created. There's more coming up here. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. But they wanted attention for their plight, and that did get them some.
Inventory isn't about products, kid. It's about money. Products sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. I hate overstock. I hate understock. I hate wasting time. I hate wasting money. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger KeepStock solutions help us manage our facility's inventory so we have exactly what we need when we need it. No more, no less. It's inventory management my way. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse me?
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything that you'd like. Toll free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether you want to talk about so-called fat shaming, which is what we opened the show with, or this bizarre death of someone who, a young man who was apparently rolled up into a wrestling mat. At least that's where he was found dead. Is the idea that he suffocated in said wrestling mat, or that he was killed beforehand and then rolled up into it? Apparently the crime has not been solved, from what I understand. Is that right?
That's correct. Yeah. It probably won't be either. If it's a crime, right? Like, you know, at this point, there is a solution, you know, like a story that the police have.
Well, he sure as hell didn't roll himself into that wrestling mat.
That's not exactly true.
Could be that he rolled himself into it and then suffocated himself.
Well, the claim
was
is...
Was he alone at the time?
The claim is, yes, he was practicing basketball and that there were... So this is a complicated story and not one that I want to dismiss just out of hand as, poo, you know, I know what happened. But so his friend and he used to wear the same shoes to practice basketball in, and they would hide them in this rolled up mat, is according to the friend, according to Wikipedia. And I tend to, you know, Wikipedia, they try to be as unbiased as they possibly can. I like them for that. So what if he jumped in to this rolled up mat from, say, a bleacher or something like that so that he could reach down and get the shoes? Somehow he slips, you know, his legs don't catch right or whatever, and his head hits the, you know, the thing. He's knocked out, or his neck is broken, or I don't think his neck was broken. I don't see any evidence of that. But I'm just saying that, you know, the claim is blunt force trauma. And, you know, he hits and he dies. People die in weird ways all the time.
That's true.
The amount of people that die from, you know, falling coconuts is really surprising. You know, toddlers kill more people than marijuana every year in the United States. You know, they get a hold of guns and shoot people. You know, people get killed by electric windows in their cars. People die in funny ways. I don't want to dismiss this.
But
now, the weirdest part is that there's some video missing from the gym, from the cameras.
Surveillance?
Yep. Now, the claim is they wouldn't have been watching this actual area, but they would have seen who came in the gym. And so there's surveillance video that's missing that would have, if somebody came in and, like, beat him up and tossed him in these mats, that's not shown. And the family's very upset about that.
And if that's the case, if somebody actually was able to access the surveillance files or
what if they're just crappy video cameras? I mean, you kind of let video cameras go. So there's a quote here, and I think this is an important one. Both the president of the Valdosta Loudness County chapter of the Southern Christian Leadership Council and the lead investigator for that chapter. So two guys. That lead investigator is also the past president of the local chapter of the NAACP. So I think the attempt here is to remove from this this claim the racism thing. Mm-hmm. So Kendrick Johnson is black, as is, I would assume, the former president of the local chapter of the NAACP.
Presumably.
If it's not, it's a really strange situation. But either way, they've stated that they believe the attorneys for the Johnsons have not entirely truthful with their statements.
And this is the Southern Christian Leadership Conference's statement?
This is a statement by two people from the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, the investigator and the president. The investigator is also the former president of the NAACP local chapter.
Hmm.
He says the lawyers have not been entirely truthful with their statements and that there is no cover-up in this case. Now, that's their claim. And, you know, I mean, like, I think that this... It's certainly a weird death, and I don't know anything else.
So basically, his parents don't believe the official story, and they want more attention brought to this. They want what they believe to be a more in-depth investigation. That's why they linked arms in front of the courthouse and prevented people from getting in the courthouse.
Most valuable thing in the world to them has been taken away,
and
that is painful.
And you know what? You know, when you've got nothing else left to live for, and I'm not saying that's the case with these folks, but certainly there's a lot less for them to live for in this case.
You know, I would like to see the suicide rate of parents that have lost children.
Yeah.
I would suspect it is significantly higher
than average.
The average rate.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, when you've got nothing left to lose, then you're more likely to be willing to do things like this, to do civil disobedience, because F it, you know, your son's not coming back. Let's go stand in front of the courthouse and, you know, get some attention for this thing.
Want some answers.
And it's very strange that time would be missing from surveillance footage. That would, you know, that almost sounds conspiratorial level at that point. Now, it's certainly possible the footage cut out for a period of time. I've dealt with surveillance systems before, and, you know, weird stuff can happen. Mm-hmm. But I don't know if they're saying that it only happened to a couple of the cameras or that the entire system was down for that period of time.
In November 2013, 290 hours of surveillance tape from 35 cameras that covered the gym area was released to CNN following a court request. A forensic analysis of analyst Grant Fredericks, enlisted by CNN, found the tapes
from
two cameras are missing 1 hour and 5 minutes of footage, while another set is missing 2 hours and 10 minutes.
That's interesting. Super suspicious.
But do you understand that so if it's on some kind of 65-minute loop, then this one lost one of them. Two of them lost one loop.
There's
and
no
then
65-minute loop. What are you talking about?
Okay, so one lost. Two of them lost 1 hour and 5 minutes, and then another set of two, I assume, is missing 2 hours and 10 minutes. That's exactly double each
coincidence.
It's just a coincidence.
First of all, this is 2013 when he died, so they're not likely using tapes. Although I suppose it could be some ancient system that the government has had running since the 1990s.
I'm not claiming it's a loop. I'm just saying that it's interesting that this, you know, the missing periods, one is exactly double the other.
I would say you're just picking up on like numerology stuff here, Mark. Okay. There's nothing to be gleaned from that. But
well, I know
these
I'm sitting
digital,
in front of
there
one
could
a-hole.
Be technical reasons for it if for some reason the video is segmented into 55-minute blocks. 65-minute blocks. It could be that somebody erased X number of blocks and they would be a multiple of
maybe.
65.
Maybe. That seems also unlikely that 65 minutes would be chosen.
Seems strange. I'm not claiming it's anything but strange.
And you have to remember that, you know, if this is a digital system, a surveillance system, then there would be no such block thing. They're just recording digital video to, you know, hard drive. Unless it actually is like an old, you know, VHS-based system or something.
It is the school, and it's 35 cameras. Replacing it would be very expensive. The cameras were motion-activated, and the mat area was believed to be outside the camera's range. Two cameras covered the entrance into the gym before Johnson's arrival and would have shown who, if anyone, had entered before him. Not after, but before. If somebody was in the gym before him, he came in, and then they murdered him and shoved him in and then it resulted in him dying, and shoved him in a mat, then it wouldn't have seen that, and perhaps, but I mean, you didn't catch them leaving either, so.
So the cameras were working that were viewing the entrance to the gym, is the suggestion here.
Those are the cameras that would have caught who went into the gym.
According to the story at CNN from November of 2013, Kendrick Johnson footage released, expert finds it highly suspicious. Their family waited months for hundreds of hours of surveillance video, hoping it would answer their questions. It raised only others. Rather than showing how their 17-year-old son's body ended up inside a school gym mat in January, the four cameras inside the Valdosta, Georgia gymnasium showed only a few collective seconds of Johnson jogging. The camera fixed on the gym mats was blurry. Compounding the family's suspicions was the nature of the gym videos. They're jumpy, with students intermittently appearing and vanishing, and they bear no obvious timestamps. That's also unusual for security footage. The Johnsons' attorneys were not shy in stating their suspicion that someone could have tampered with the videos. They know their child didn't climb into a wrestling mat, get stuck, and die. Where is that video? Benjamin Crump asked. Attorney Chevin King questioned why time codes weren't shown in the videos. Quote, "We don't have any time code to which to synchronize the events that are being shown in the video. Either the cameras did this on their own, or a human being interacted to make these cameras do these things," said King. Crump further said the family believes someone corrupted the video. Lowndes County Schools insists the video is a raw feed with no edits, and the county sheriff's office, which asserts Johnson accidentally died while reaching for a shoe in one of the mats, says it didn't edit any of the files, according to their attorneys. CNN, which filed suit to secure access to the video, hired forensic video analyst Grant Fredericks to analyze more than 290 hours of material from all 35 cameras inside and outside of the gym. This man who analyzed the cameras is a U.S. Justice Department consultant and contract instructor
for
the FBI.
And he claims it's suspicious?
That's what he said.
I claim it's suspicious, too, but I think that, you know, once CNN has hired an analyst to go over 290 hours of video, you've got all the answers you're going to get. You know, I mean, unless we can find this missing video, you know, I don't, and the people who took it, you know, I mean, they've got whatever reasons they've got for not getting out there. I hope of.
We'll come back with more. There's a little bit more to the story about the expert that reviewed the footage. We'll come back with that on Free Talk Live.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, January 26, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,295, silver at $18.32, and Bitcoin is trading around $282.71. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by WatchMyBit.com, the first ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. In the news, WikiLeaks is demanding answers after Google recently revealed they handed over emails and data from employees of the journalistic outfit to the U.S. government. The information was part of a secret search warrant issued in March 2012, and Google was bound by a gag order from revealing the request. Now, WikiLeaks lawyer Michael Ratner of the Center for Constitutional Rights is asking Google's executive chairman to detail what materials were given to the FBI and whether or not the company challenged the warrant. Julian Assange, WikiLeaks founder and editor-in-chief, said the actions by the FBI were part of a larger conspiracy case against him and his staff.
If I thought it would save an American life, I'd do things far worse than anything that made it into that report. I might even stick a power drill through somebody's knee.
That's what Michael, an anonymous former military contractor, told the anti-media in a recent interview. The former contractor discussed his role in torturing suspected terrorists in the Middle East. Michael says the recent Senate report on the use of torture is giving soldiers a bad name. He goes on to admit to participating in waterboarding, sleep deprivation, and beatings of detainees. For more on this exclusive interview, visit theantimedia.org.
The public feud between police accountability activists and the Arlington, Texas Police Department continues, as two members of Texas Cop Lock were arrested Saturday afternoon for exercising their First and Second Amendment rights simultaneously. Officers can be seen warning activists to put all weapons, including their openly carried black powder pistols, back into their vehicles while they film the police, or they would be subject to arrest. Two activists did not comply to their orders and were arrested for disorderly conduct and interfering with police business. They were bailed out in a matter of hours. Your job, your home, your car, your money. All of these things provide you with a sense of security. But what about your family security? What have you done to prepare if all of these things were suddenly gone? eFoods Direct has the food security you need. For every emergency, eFoods Direct is food security. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for 50% off their food preparation planning packs. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, January 26, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. 18 people are dead, including a 10-year-old boy, during protests in Egypt Sunday, marking the fourth anniversary of the country's uprising in 2011. 35 others were reported injured during the protests, while 140 were arrested. The Telegraph reports the violence happened in the neighborhood that served as the battleground that led to the ousting of Hosni Mubarak from his seat of power. On Wednesday, the Dallas City Council will vote on whether or not to discontinue water fluoridation. After heavy lobbying from local activists, the city council will take up the controversial issue and decide whether or not to resign their contract. In early December, Mayor Mike Rawlings delayed a vote at the request of Councilman Sheffy Cadane. Cadane has been a vocal opponent of water fluoridation, stating the city can save $1 million by voting no. A British biotechnology company is hoping to gain approval to release genetically engineered mosquitoes in the Florida Keys. Oxitec has patented a method of breeding a mosquito with genes from the herpes simplex virus and E. coli bacteria, as well as coral and cabbage. The release of the GE mosquito is an attempt at fighting viruses by having the mosquitoes bite residents. The Food and Drug Administration would have to approve the trials before the insects could be released. Over 130,000 people have signed a petition to stop the experiment. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, live each Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern. Hot topics from a unique Liberty perspective. Catch it at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, January 26, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
I mean, it's just so hard to believe that it's really all gone.
It was in this living room 3 weeks ago that the Talbot family discovered their DVR had suddenly and inexplicably crashed, deleting more than 5 years worth of recorded live events and miniseries.
I keep having flashbacks to that day, to that moment when I realized everything was gone.
You know, you hear stories about people who mismanage their device settings, but you never really think it could happen to you. Honestly, it feels like some sort of a dream. Like, when I wake up, I'll be able to just go downstairs, turn on the TV, and all the episodes will be there again, as if nothing had ever happened.
Friends and family of the Talbots have pledged their support, organizing DVD donations and offering passwords to online streaming services while the family struggles to move on.
We know that we'll never be able to replace all the hours of programming that we had, but I think in the end, we'll be just fine. As long as we have our 5 seasons of Seinfeld on DVD.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You may dial toll-free to bring up whatever's on your mind. More about the Kendrick Johnson case. It's actually in the news again, not just because E-Rod called us tonight, but also because apparently his parents are now facing criminal charges of interfering with government administration, or whatever the variant is called down in Georgia, of that particular charge. They're going to a jury trial on this. They were protesting the fact that they just feel like the investigation has been suboptimal from the sheriff's department. And when you get suboptimal performance from the government police, your options are very, very slim. There aren't very many things you can do about it. You can try to get attention from the media, which, you know, if this is an old story, and this is now at this point, it's over a year old. It's like 2 years old since since this young man was found dead, rolled up in a wrestling mat in a high school gym. The news media is not going to be interested in reporting on how the parents are upset with the police. You know, you can go knock on the newspaper's door and knock on the TV station's door, call the news editors up, and they're going to tell you, well, thanks for the idea, but, you know, we'll follow up with you if we feel it's necessary. And they're just not going to report on it. So these folks took an extra step. They went and they locked arms in front of the courthouse, and I don't know if they what else they did to block the way, but they were not moving to let people in or out of the courthouse, from what I understand. The police, of course, eventually arrested them, although they say they did give them the chance to leave. They, you know, kind of asked them to, all right, look, you know, this is enough. You need to get out. You need to move out of the way, let people get in and out of this building. And they didn't. And so that resulted in charges. And so it did get them some extra publicity. That was what they intended to do. And there's more about the story here, but let's go to your calls and thoughts. It's Ian, Rich, and Mark in the studio. We've got Liberty Phoenix on the line in Illinois via Skype. Hello, Liberty Phoenix. Hey there, can barely hear you. I don't know if your mic is turned way down or something like that.
Is this better?
Oh, yes.
It's
yes,
a huge sir. Difference. Did you have it in your pocket?
Right. No, I think the mixer might be messed up. I'm going through a couple of different ones right now, and I just rewired this one. But at the risk of, you know, risking the, you know, the threats from the mobs, I'm going to go out there and say that whoever the individual was that committed this act is not an evil person, as the original caller had said.
Hold on. Slow down for a second. Whoever committed this act, you mean the police officer who arrested the parents for blocking entrance to the courthouse?
No, the individuals that murdered their son.
Well, it's not clear whether or not their son was murdered at this point. And Erod, who called earlier, was not calling the people who allegedly or ostensibly killed this young man bad people. He was referring to the police.
Well, I just simply mean the term of monsters. I don't think we should be collectivizing anybody by you know, dehumanizing them like that. The police are not monsters. They're victims of a society which reinforces the actions that if you just do what you're told, you'll get good things. Humans are naturally adaptive, so they will go towards whatever positive reinforcement is in their realm of scope. But you know, I just wanted to point out that when he had called them at the end of his call, he had called them all monsters and everything. And it's a really bad idea to dehumanize your enemies, because
I don't think
that
it's
is
a really bad idea. But I think I would call it a very human thing to do.
Sure, he's upset for good reason.
I think that also when somebody's upset, it's not the time to have this discussion. But I agree with what you're saying. I think none of these people are monsters. They're human beings doing human being stuff. And when you say they're monsters, you're doing the thing that it takes in order to. This is how humans pit each other against each other. You know.
Yeah, that's how we rationalize. And you're absolutely
Phoenix,
right.
Can you back off your mic a little bit? It's a little bit too loud now. Sorry.
Not a problem. Teaching hospital. You're absolutely right, though. He about the part where he was very emotional about it. And it's times like that where we have to step back and say, all right, I'm letting my emotions control me. I'm not going to be coming at this topic from a rational, logical perspective. And I'm going to, you know, say something wrong or categorize someone in a correct way. Or I'm going to act out aggressively when it's not warranted or a different approach would work.
Well, I can also empathize with Erod, because there are certain times when, yes, I know these guys, these government bureaucrats, are human beings. They have feelings. They have families. I get that. But there are some times when they act so cold, and when they act as though they're almost automatons and very, you know, very much disconnected from whatever humanity that is somewhere deep inside of them. And so I can totally understand the frustration that people have, where they feel like they're being mistreated and they feel like that the people they care about are being ignored and sidelined and treated, you know, like dirt or like.
Absolutely right. But the operative word there, Ian, is when they act, it's their actions that are monstrous. It's their actions that are evil and should be despised. It's not the individuals themselves, because individuals can always be recovered. An individual can always change their path in life. No matter how horrible they've been, they can always be redeemed. So it's the actions that are monstrous, not the people.
Yeah, it's and another thing is sort of, you know, when one looks at somebody who's done a horrible thing, this is this is something that people have to look on a relatively regular basis because when you see people on the news, you just know what they say about them on the news. But when you know somebody in real life that perhaps has committed a crime or is a victim of a crime or something like that, you come face to face with this. You know, if somebody does something terrible and they generally live a pretty good life and do pretty good stuff, it's easy to just go after that person and say that, you know, they're monsters, they're a terrible person, whatever. You never really know anybody or whatever it is that you say. I contend we are all capable of this. We're all capable of these evil, heinous acts, or at least some evil, heinous acts. And that too, cluck our fingers and somehow suggest that these people are different. They're monsters or they're animals or, you know, whatever. They're less than human. They're inhumane. Whatever it is that you say about them is to try to distance yourself from the evil within you, your dark side. And that, I think that's a really cheap, it's a cheap way to think about things.
I couldn't agree more, but I'll leave you guys with this. Every mass killing, every major act of democide in the history of humanity has been caused and propagated because people were allowed themselves to dehumanize people.
I think you're right. I mean, there's no doubt about it, and I appreciate the perspective, Liberty Phoenix. Thank you for the call tonight. Hey, by the way, weren't you planning on... Oh, he hung up. Well, anyway, good call. I heard he was moving to New Hampshire soon. I was going to ask him about that, but anyway, you can join us here in New Hampshire. You can go to freestateproject.org. There's a movement of liberty-oriented folks who care about freedom. They're coming up here, and they're getting active. And I have to say that I was able to see the police as human beings after moving here to New Hampshire. Prior to that, I just considered them a bunch of thugs and did not think highly in any way, shape, or form of the police when I lived down in Florida. And I still brought those beliefs with me when I moved up here. But up here, we're in such a small place. These communities are very, very small. Like in Keene, there's 25,000 people. There's 40 uniformed police officers on the Keene Police Department. In Manchester, which is the largest city in New Hampshire, there's 200 uniformed officers. So that it's getting a little large in Manchester, but in most cities or towns in New Hampshire, you can know who all of the police are. And of course, they know who you are, too. And there's a level of connection that happens there over time as activists are out and about, you know, doing cop block or, you know, coming to the aid of innocents that are being harassed by the police. You're going to inevitably create a rapport with these guys. You're going to have some level of a relationship with them, and guys and gals, because there's some ladies on the police force. And I think that's just so immensely valuable to actually know who the police are, because if you know them and they know you, they can't as easily treat you like you're a monster. They can't as easily treat you as though, you know, you are this unknown thing that needs to be treated with the most dangerous way possible, right? Like that you're somebody who's a threat to them.
Well, we're very lucky to be dealing with KPD instead of NYPD.
Oh, absolutely. And I think that the police are a cut better up here in New Hampshire than in a lot of places. And I think one of the reasons for that is that they're just more connected. In New York, you're never going to see the same cop twice. But in New Hampshire, you'll see them all the time. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and I think there's real value there for the Liberty Movement. 855-450-3733. That's not to say they won't arrest you if they've been told to arrest you. They certainly will. But they're probably less likely to beat your head off the pavement in the process here. More coming up. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Listen, you've heard the commercials before. Whether you owe $15,000 or $15 million in tax debt to the IRS or state, we can help. On a never-ending payment plan? Penalties and interest killing you? Missing tax returns? Being garnished or levied? Not a problem. If you qualify, we can remove levies and garnishments within days or even hours of hiring our firm. If you've been summoned, or even worse, receiving tax warrants in the mail, call right now. Are you a business owner with back payroll taxes? Is the IRS or state threatening to close your business you've worked so hard to build? Protect yourself and your business. Even if you've tried in the past, new guidelines could potentially qualify you today. So what are you waiting for? We can take that tax monkey off your back.
Call the Tax Monkey now. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. That's 800-281-6030.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Majid lives in Nor Deven, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you'd like. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. And enjoy the features waiting for you there. Now, online privacy matters, and you need to take steps to protect your privacy. One of the things you can do is to get ProXPN, and you can go and get it right now for free. Download their software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, or Android, and get it installed. It only takes a moment, and once ProXPN is activated, once you're connected to it, your internet connection will be encrypted. Right now, your internet service provider is probably logging all of the websites you visit, the search terms you're entering, keeping those logs maybe as long as 5 years in some cases. You can put a stop to that right now by going and getting ProXPN. And by the way, if you're a Linux user, you can also get ProXPN operational pretty quickly. ProXPN.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to their premium account to get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. When you want to upgrade to that account, that premium account, you just use code FTL50, FTL like Free Talk Live, and the number 50, as in 50% off of the price of the annual account, which breaks the price down to around $5 per month.
And by the way, that savings is locked in for the lifetime of your account. So there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits at all. Go to proxpn.com/FTL, and don't forget promo code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we continue here, we can talk more about the Kendrick Johnson case and the video footage that one expert is saying the fact that some of it's missing, highly suspicious. But first, Alma is in Florida. Alma, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, and Mark.
I'm about to go to sleep here. I've got two quick comments on the E-Rod and the six-packs, and I really wanted to talk a minute about this is really important about the storm of the century because it's not storm of the century. But on E-Rod, I live 60 miles from Valdosta. This is what's going on. It's been on the news forever. Right's right and wrong's wrong, and this is wrong. We live in a lawless land.
What are you saying is wrong? I just want to be clear. What is wrong?
Wrong is what's going on with the little fella. It's wrong, and their parents, that's wrong.
The teenager who was found rolled up dead
in a school wrestling mat? It all reeks of wrong.
So you're saying that you don't think the official story is accurate, he hit his head.
You look at the good old boys. You look in this little tiny little county I live in Georgia. You get pepper sprayed, you go to jail, in 3 hours you're dead. And it ain't the first time. It won't be the last time. You can be in the ditch and nobody's going to do nothing about it. We live in a lawless land, and everybody better pay attention. All right, now I want to move on to the six-pack.
All right.
All right, the six-pack I had one time was 37. I got a picture to prove it at 34, and all it is wrong with women, if they don't got it, they hate your guts for it.
You know what? There's a lot of jealousy. I think you're absolutely right about that, Alma. And I just want to bring our listeners up to speed. You're referring to the very first story that Mark was talking about tonight, where a young lady at age 33, she's a mom. She's got six-pack abs. She's very, very pretty. And there are people who are super angry at her, you know, basically posting pictures of herself and, you know, trying to psych herself up to be as fit as possible and trying to encourage others. And they're jealous, aren't they?
I'm 60 and I still look good. You take pride in yourself. If you don't have any pride in yourself, that you look in the mirror, you have nobody to blame but yourself. Quit blaming someone who does have pride in themselves.
Good thoughts, Alma. Thanks for the call tonight.
Wait. No, this is most important thing I want to talk to you about.
Okay, hurry.
This is really important because this storm of the century ain't a storm of no century. We knew it to begin with. All this is to bring martial law on us.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Oh, yes, you do, and you're not going to say it. Right?
There are a lot of excuses to bring martial law down. But
there were just plow trucks out where I was.
In Boston, it had no travel.
Oh, that's true. There were no travel restrictions.
Well, now I do want to clarify something that, Mark, you seem to be of the belief that someone would not get in an arrest for traveling or ticket or whatever.
They would.
They were threatening tickets in Connecticut. That much is true.
Everybody to be little sheep. You do what I say. Because after you don't do it so many times, you get on that street and you're going to this place or you're going to be dead.
Good advice tonight, Alma. Thank you for making the call.
I
appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I think it was either New York or Connecticut. They were absolutely threatening people with $300 tickets.
I'm sure they are. I didn't claim that they wouldn't get tickets. I claimed that they likely wouldn't pull people over and say, hey, where are you going? Mm. That if you're in a ditch and you...
That's what you said. Yeah, that's
true. And then they say, where were you headed? And you say, to the liquor store to get some beer, that's when you get the ticket, as opposed to saying, I'm going to work at a gas station, which they consider to be on the list of, mandatory or necessary or whatever work. When I was on the road, I saw, you know, on the state road, I saw two cars pass me on the way in, and I'd say that's about a 7 or 8 mile stretch. Not a lot of cars out there, so a lot of people are choosing not to be on the road. But downtown in Keene, there were people going all over the place. And
well, travel's not banned in New Hampshire.
It's not banned at all, but they're also, all of them were under 30 miles an hour, you know, so they're just sort of crawling along.
As you should in conditions like this. So anyway, back to the story here from the Kendrick Johnson case. The CNN had a report where they hired a guy to actually go through 290 hours of footage from 35 security cameras inside and outside the gym where this young man was found dead in a rolled up in a wrestling mat. Now, the expert Fredericks did knock down most of the family's concerns when he reviewed this. They're all easily explained, he says, but his examination raised what could be another mystery, at least an hour of missing video from all four cameras. The Wikipedia article said two cameras.
No, it said four.
Oh, did
two,
I'm sorry.
Two sets of two.
Ah, okay. Those are not original files, said Fredericks. They're not something investigators should rely on for the truth of the video. Addressing the family's suspicions, Frederick said the erratic motion in the video can be attributed to motion sensors triggering the camera's recording function, and the blurriness on the camera homing in on the gym mats is a product of an out-of-focus lens. As for the timestamp, it's there, he says. Investigators just need to know where to look. Fredericks was able to find a little more than 18 minutes of video showing Johnson throughout the school on January 10th. He's first seen at 7:30 in the morning entering the school and last seen at 1:09 p.m. walking into the gym where he was found dead the next day. What Fredericks wasn't able... Now, 1 p.m.? I mean, it doesn't seem like that would be an empty gym at 1 o'clock in the
afternoon.
Yeah,
but as I understand it, these mats... Okay, so the story is that he hid his shoes or that
hid his shoes.
Well... He and a friend shared a pair of shoes, mm-hmm. And you know that they hid the shoes in order for them not to be found. You're not going to put those out in the middle of God and everything, right? They're going to be in a corner, and so mm-hmm. this is where the mats are stored. This isn't where you know they were using these mats to do things. This is where they're stored. So he goes back in his little hidey hole for the shoes, you know, smacks his head or whatever happens. This is the claim, right? And I don't know what happened.
Yep.
You know, maybe it's a terrible murder. I have no clue. But, you know, I guess there's reasonable doubt in this case, and we obviously don't have a killer. We might have a cover-up, but we don't have a killer.
And is the idea that he, like, jumped down the center of one of these mats
as I understand
and hit
it.
His head on the floor?
As I understand it, that's the story.
Wow. All right, we'll come back with more here from the video expert analysis. And your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. Coming up, jurors kidnapped from the streets. It's happened again. And it seems like this happens more often than you might think. We'll tell you more. It's Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090. Call 1-800-467-5090.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Anti-war, pro-free market. That's antiwar.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like here toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. Mark, tell me how to get a pound of some of the best coffee out there.
Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. If you've been listening to Free Talk Live, you'd know that you can go get a pound of the best coffee. It's shade grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica beans. It's Buzzbox Coffee. We've teamed up with them. And the reason we did isn't because they offer really great coffee, because they do. But the reason is because they give us back some money so that we can loan it out. Some of the profits get loaned out through Kiva.org to make people's lives better around the world. We've managed to loan out quite a few loans, and when they get paid back, we're going to use the money to loan it back again. It's a great cycle of giving, and I think it's wonderful. It's coffee.freetalklive.com. You can get a free pound there. You sign up for a subscription. Once you get your free pound, if you like it, then you can sort of customize it. You can get wider varieties. You can get them delivered, 2 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, whatever you want. You can order more or less depending on how much you drink. I say order a little bit extra, because if you end up with extra coffee at some point, you can just give a pound to a friend and then recommend coffee.freetalklive.com to them. So it's coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Just kind of learning more as we go here about this Kendrick Johnson case, where a young man age 17 was found dead inside of a wrestling mat, which was rolled up and ostensibly was vertical at the time that his body was found. And Rich Paul, you say you've had some experience with these wrestling mats, and that it would be very unusual to store one of these vertically. Is that right?
I've never seen them stored vertically.
Yeah, I haven't either. Generally, I mean, you can make sort of a triangle out of it, usually, these mats. They're like three sections, and you can make a triangle out of it. I don't know why one would do that. It is all very suspicious, but what if you wanted a place to store your shoes and you didn't want anybody to bother it? I don't know. But it would seem to me, if it was just one wrestling mat, that he probably would have just picked it up, moved it, and gotten his shoes. Like, this had to have been something kind of heavy for him to jump down on into the inside of it, if that's the claim.
That's the theory,
if they're using the large wrestling mats,
yep.
The ones that roll up, could not
probably have a difficult time with those that easily. Yeah.
So there's some confusing stuff here in this story from CNN.com where they had a video guy look at 290 hours of footage from 35 different cameras inside and outside of the gym. Now, we had talked earlier about how there was missing footage, but what the article reveals is that the missing footage doesn't really even cover the time frame when this young man died, which is also very strange. So here's what it says here. Two cameras in the gym are missing an hour and 5 minutes. Their hiatus ending at 1:09 when Johnson enters the gym. Another pair of cameras are missing 2 hours and 10 minutes each. They don't begin recording again until 1:15 and 1:16, according to their timestamps. So it sounds to me like there were only two cameras that were only missing about 6 minutes worth of footage here. And I don't imagine he died within the first 5 minutes of going into the gym because there's footage of him running around in the gym. So I have to say I'm baffled, you know, having not spent a whole lot of time really researching the
details. I think there were four cameras, and they were missing different sections, and that there was a total of six minutes that's completely unaccounted for,
yeah.
And then some pieces that are unaccounted for with different cameras depending on the situation. The claim is that you don't necessarily know who it was in the gym before he arrived in.
What's certain, based on video from a camera outside the gym, is that numerous students walked into the gym during the hour and 5 minutes that the cameras weren't recording, but it's not clear whether that was sufficient to activate those cameras' motion sensors. The timestamp on the camera outside the gym also appears to be 10 minutes behind the cameras in the gym. Frederick said, this is the video expert, quote, "I can't tell you whether there was no information recorded in the digital video system or whether somebody made an error and didn't capture it or whether somebody just didn't provide it. CNN has requested access to the original surveillance servers, but Frederick's cautions that the video could be gone as newer surveillance would replace it if it wasn't recovered promptly from the school's digital video recorders." We do know that they were digital videos. This wasn't some old VHS-based system or whatever. And Frederick said he found it highly suspicious that an hour of video could be missing, especially considering how the material was acquired by the police. The police have said they didn't receive a copy of the videos until several days after the body was found, according to an unredacted report found by CNN. And the investigator also says that the police's responsibility, their investigator's responsibility, is to acquire the entire digital video recording system and have their staff define what it is that they want to obtain. It doesn't sound like that happened in this case. According to an incident report from the sheriff's office, however, a detective watched a portion of the video, then asked an information technology officer employed by the school board to produce a, quote, copy of the surveillance video for the entire wing of the school with the old gym for the last 48 hours. 5 days later, according to the sheriff's report, the IT officer delivered a hard drive to the detective, who verified that it contained what he had requested. So, it's just a bizarre case. It really is. And I can totally understand why his parents are upset to the point where they're willing to commit civil disobedience in order to try to bring more information out about this, to try to have a better investigation done.
But imagine the world. I mean, these are motion-activated cameras, and who knows whether they activated when they were supposed to activate. But imagine the world where you didn't have cameras and you were just sort of stuck with, well, looks like he jumped into a mat tube and broke his neck. Sorry. Or, you know, busted his head. Sorry. You know, like, that's going to be really dissatisfying, too. This only, here in this
that
case.
That story is very dissatisfying, I have to
it
say.
Is, but people die in very strange ways.
Sure, and, you know, young people do some dumb things sometimes, right?
Right. Like, for instance, I used to work at a magazine, and a guy who was on our staff died. He had gotten drunk, and he fell asleep, and, he leaned against the neighbor's car at a duplex, right? Like, the driveways are right next to each other, kind of texting his girlfriend or whatever while he's drunk. He passes out, basically, from bibing alcohol. The neighbor gets out early in the morning and backs out over him.
Oh, God.
It's terrible, right? Now, imagine for a second if that had been the girlfriend, a girl, you know, does this, and then her boyfriend, who's sleeping and then going to the work the next day, backs out over her. Imagine all the suspicion that would have been in play there simply because they're in a relationship. Because this is a neighbor, you don't have quite the suspicion. But this could be a very suspicious circumstance, very unsatisfying. But, you know,
people die in unsatisfying, weird, ways all the time. I don't know.
Sometimes a cigar is just a cigar.
Sometimes it is.
All right, so you can take control here, whether you want to share your thoughts on this suspicious death of this young man or not. Whatever's on your mind goes here. There was a story about a jury that I thought was worth sharing here tonight. And it's coming out of Eau Claire, Wisconsin, WEAU, reporting. Imagine going about your daily routine. You're running errands and perhaps running by the mall, but that's where you see Eau Claire County Sheriff Ron Kramer approaching you. He says he needs jurors, and you have to go with him right then, right now. That's not funny. That's kidnapping.
It's funny because, I mean, just imagine what... No, I can't go.
You're under arrest.
Right. I mean, it's just weird.
Mm-hmm.
That is exactly what happened. Eau Claire Sheriff Ron Kramer had this topic come up at a meeting earlier this week. He never thought today would be the day. Sheriff Kramer says, quote, "We did talk about cases like this where a number of people have to go out and get people summoned to the jury. Eau Claire County Circuit Court Judge Michael Schumacher needed jurors for a trial taking place Thursday afternoon when the list of potential jurors ran out. The Wisconsin statute on insufficient jurors then came into play. Susan Schaefer, the Eau Claire County Clerk of Courts, then reached out to Sheriff Kramer, so he had to hit the streets. Quote, "It's something that doesn't happen very often. It just so happened that today was the day we needed more. The court can order the sheriff to get people right off the street." Now, coming up, they're going to actually share with us what questions were asked of the people in the streets. And there's a way, I would say, that you can avoid getting kidnapped in this case. More coming up. 855-450-FREE.
Tell me you have AIDS.
855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Inventory isn't about products, kid. It's about money. Product sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. I hate overstock. I hate understock. I hate wasting time. I hate wasting money. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger KeepStock solutions help us manage our facility's inventory so we have exactly what we need when we need it. No more, no less. It's inventory management my way. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
You ever hear about Ghost 80% AR-15 rifle kits? At Guns80.com, they are the 80% specialists, helping to protect our privacy. Look, there are forces out there right now trying to register guns for future confiscation. UN treaties threatening our Second Amendment and our freedom. You need a Ghost AR-15. Get it at Guns80.com. Call 844-2GUNS80. That's 844-248-6780. Own an AR-15 today and keep it a secret. Go to Guns80.com. That's Guns80.com. 844-2GUNS80.
Good people need help. The Homeowners Association said we had weeds and fined us $25. We told them they had the wrong house. They said if we didn't pay it, they'd file a lien. Our attorney demanded photographs, witnesses, and told them if they couldn't provide this, they must cease and desist. Issue solved. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Geneticists gathered at a conference this week to debate the ethics of cloning human beings and compelling them to fight to the death in a rock-filled pit for our amusement. Experts at the conference reportedly discussed questions key to the scientific field, such as the morality of arming hundreds of clones with maces and pitting them against each other on a small platform surrounded by molten lava.
Cloning humans and goading them into viciously battling certainly raises ethical questions. It's important that we consider this topic with an open mind. Whether or not we should be stranding clones on a desert island, assigning them weapons biologically, lottery system and making them murder one another tournament style remains a matter up for debate.
And in this week's local news, a man is wearing a low-cut swimsuit as though a public pool is some kind of sun-kissed Sardinian cove. In other news, China's veteran reporters blast the decline of traditional state-run journalism. A new study finds human hearing is most acute when listening to arguing parents from the top of the stairs. And fireflies almost managed to salvage a local man's shitty day.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Rich Paul's here courtesy of nhjury.com. You can go there and learn more about your right to nullify when you are on a jury. And by the way, the information you'll find at nhjury.com isn't just about New Hampshire. It pretty much is applicable in most places. But what we did was we created our own jury outreach, jury
most
rights.
Most English common law places.
Yeah. Jury outreach, jury rights group. And that's what nhjury.com is. Rich, you're one of the board members of that group. So check that out. And there's, you know, blog posts up there as well, and kind of following along with news about jury nullification. And there's a great Facebook page also for nhjury.com. So speaking of juries, that's what we're talking about at the moment, where in Eau Claire, Wisconsin, one of the sheriffs was ordered by a court judge to go and capture people from the streets of Eau Claire for the purposes of bringing them onto a jury pool. And that's exactly what this man did. According to the story by WEAU.com.
What a crazy thing to be sent out to do. Hey, go get some people. We need a jury.
But it's not the first time that we've reported on this. We have talked about stories like this in the past. And it's maybe we've only talked about it once in the past, because it really doesn't seem to happen too often. At least it doesn't make the news too often when it does happen. I wonder how frequently this does go on across the country. This officer says it doesn't happen very often. And I believe that that's probably true, because usually, you know, most jury pools have dozens of people showing up and they probably have enough folks. But every now and then, it doesn't work out, or enough people don't show, or just enough people aren't qualified, or they're dismissed to where they've got to go and fill that jury up. And so apparently when approached, three questions were asked. One, are you an Eau Claire County resident? Now, you're under no obligation to speak to a police officer when he approaches you on the streets.
If it's the first thing they ask you, then you're like... Okay, so from a sales standpoint, this is the right question to ask, because you qualify the subject while they're still interested in sort of what you're talking about. You haven't given them the information yet. If you go up and say, hey, would you like to be a juror today? Then,
sure.
You know, then that's a different set.
They're not asking you if you want to be a juror, right?
Well, they are.
They're asking you these questions so they can then take you.
I understand.
To the jury. Yeah.
So if you know the purpose of the questions, you're more likely to find a way to outwit.
Possibly.
The kidnappers.
Yeah. And most people are cooperative with the police, or a lot of people are. And so they will answer these questions. But my point is, if you wanted to avoid this conflict, if you want to avoid the prospect of being whisked off the streets in the midst of your day and placed into a courthouse as a juror, then simply follow the rule of don't talk to the police. If you follow the rule of don't talk to the police, then they cannot garner the information about you unless they already know you personally. Like, this wouldn't work for me, although they wouldn't come after me to put me on a jury in Keene, New Hampshire.
No, they don't want you there.
But, you know, if they know who you are, if they know you're a, you know, Clare County resident or Eau Claire County resident, and then question number two, are you at least 18 years of age? And question number three, do you have any history of a felony conviction? Presumably, if they know the answers to those three, then they can just take you. But if you give them the answers to those three, then you're essentially putting yourself in a position where they can take you. So you're talking yourself into being kidnapped in this case.
Well, if you know they're taking you for jury duty and you don't want to go, then the easiest thing to do is say, well, yeah, sure, I'll go with you, but no matter what evidence you show me, I won't return a guilty verdict.
Wait a minute. Not even on a murder case, Rich Paul?
Well, if you say that, you're not going to be on the jury at all. True. They're just going to leave you on the street and take somebody else.
Good point.
Now, of course, I would love to be on a jury, so I'd be looking at the opposite thing. How can I get them to take me?
Yeah.
well, being a felon, that wouldn't be easy.
So no felons are ever allowed on a jury? I didn't know that.
I think until your voting rights are restored in New Hampshire.
I don't know the specifics.
Yeah, I wonder about that. Okay, well, you can share your thoughts here with us, and if you've ever experienced this, we'd certainly love to hear from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. According to the story here at WEAU, unless those that were approached wrote down their personal information and agreed to drive themselves to the courthouse, the sheriff's department would physically bring them to the courthouse. Quote, I gave a couple of them rides home, and they thought it was a very interesting process they've never heard of before, but the judge did explain why they were taken off the street so they could move on with the trial. In the end, the trial ended up getting pushed back to another date. Even after they had an appropriate number, the judge felt the jury was still insufficient to handle the case properly, so those selected are apparently off the hook. But this really just kind of reveals jury duty for what it actually is. It's a draft. You are being drafted into government service for an indeterminate period of time, usually a fairly short period. But in some cases, like the Ross Ulbricht case going on right now in Manhattan, that trial's in its third week now, and it's expected to be 4 to 6 weeks long. The prosecution witnesses are not even half done yet, I don't think, or they're getting close to being half done. So that's a long time to take off from work, and you're forced to essentially be in this process.
And these jurors are paid $15 a day,
or something,
I believe.
Some sort of pittance.
Something absurd.
I think it's different by state. I think it's $15 a day in New Hampshire, and they give you a lunch, and that's it.
You know, I wonder. So juries, I don't have much faith in juries anymore. I've seen enough cases where I'm just like, this should be, you know, this person should be found innocent, and they're not. And I'm just of the opinion that these amateurs really have no business doing this stuff. You know, they do what they're told, lockstep. They don't ask, you know, they don't question. They don't seem to hold a reasonable doubt, to my mind. And they don't care anything about sort of rights and that sort of thing. They seem to care about going home. They seem to care about it's sort of a study in the way groups function, because so many of them are like, okay, well, he says it's the way to do it, and I guess we better do it that way.
12 Angry Men.
Yeah, I've never seen that movie.
Oh, it's a good one.
I don't know what the solutions are other than paid arbiters that don't work for the government. It seems like is the best way to do it, or a group of paid arbiters that don't work for the government, because court cases are just so long. It seems like they're confrontational in the sense that they're not trying to work. Everybody's not trying to work towards a solution. It seems to be about who can lie better, and the state spends no money. One side has no problem spending all the money in the world because it's not their money. The other side, it's you trying to defend yourself, or in a civil case, you're out fighting this big company and there's no way you can win. It's just the court system's so messed up.
Robert Heinlein, actually, in The Moon is a Harsh Mistress, wrote Professional Jurors. So it's kind of in between a mediator and a jury, in that you do have a jury, but the jury is composed of people who hear cases professionally. It's just that there's a panel of them rather than just one.
Also, when you have a situation where, like with Russ Ulbricht, for instance, there's a lot of cryptography and security and privatization software and all that stuff. Why in the world are we taking the average Joe off the street, the average, you know, mouth breather, and having them judge this case when we should be getting a panel of security experts or something like that? You know, why does it have to be so tied down to a geographic area? Why do they just randomly select people?
Well, it's funny that you bring that up, Mark, because I've had some show prep about that very issue here for a number of days. It's not really front and center to the Ulbricht trial, but Vice.com filed a report about 2 weeks ago about what the judge had to say about their own jury. As the jury began hearing testimony in the case, it was clear the technological knowledge gap would impede proceedings. Judge Catherine Forrest said right off the bat when the case began that, quote, highly technical issues must be made clear to the jury. She said, if I believe things are not understandable to the average juror, we will talk about what might be a reasonable way to proceed at that time. After the first day of proceedings, Forrest told the prosecution to be more clear with explanations of concepts central to the case, noting she was unhappy with its mumbo-jumbo explanation of the anonymizing service Tor. She also requested all readings of chat transcripts include emoticons. The majority of the second day of testimony from Homeland Security Special Investigation Agent Jared Yegahan continued setting the groundwork for the case, explaining in depth many concepts central to the Silk Road. U.S. Attorney Saren Turner's questioning was so thorough it bordered on tedious for the more tech-savvy observer, asking Duryegahan to explain Wiki, Internet Chat, and AdBuddy. There's a distinct knowledge gap between what an average juror or judge can be expected to already know and the intricacies of modern cybercrime. This is true of any legal case, of course. In any courtroom, there are terms, specifics, and details that the lawyers have to walk the jury through in order to make their case. But when it comes to the web, that knowledge gap becomes even wider. Nate Cardozo, the staff attorney for the EFF, says as a lawyer and as a judge, you have to become an expert in whatever each case happens to be about. And obviously these juries are certainly not. There's more coming up here in moments. You can share your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, January 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.96 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,284 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $265. Antiwar.com reports from Kurdish officials say that after 112 days of fighting, they have finally expelled the Islamic State from the contested border city of Kobani and that their YPG militias are now fully in control. YPG officials confirmed the takeover, and the city's deputy foreign minister said there will be an official announcement of victory on Tuesday. The Islamic State has launched several offensives against Kobani and so far failed to take the city, the last major Kurdish holding to their west. The final death toll of the latest battle was 979 the Islamic State fighters and 324 YPG fighters. Kobani's value to the Islamic State is twofold, as it is both a border crossing into Turkey and would give the Islamic State contiguous control over a vast span of the border and increasingly near the city of Aleppo. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Ars Technica reports, prosecutors in the Silk Road drug trafficking trial have shown heaps of evidence from the laptop they seized from Ross Ulbricht, the man they allege is the kingpin behind the world's biggest drug trafficking website. What hasn't been known until Monday is what exactly led them to Ulbricht. A Homeland Security agent who testified last week had been investigating the site since it became famous in mid-2011, but it wasn't until September 2013 that he heard the name Ross Ulbricht. Days later, Ulbricht was arrested. Yesterday, IRS Special Agent Gary Alford took the stand and explained how he got onto Ulbricht's trail using one of the most basic tools on the internet, Google. Even though the Silk Road operated only on Tor, the part of the internet sometimes referred to as the Darknet, Alford knew it had to be marketed somewhere. Alford said on the stand, "I figured it had to be on the regular internet so someone could tell you where to go." In June 2013, he searched for Silk Road and .onion, looking only for web references that predated January 31st, 2011, the very beginning of the market. That search led him to a post on BitcoinTalk.org called A Heroin Story. The post quoted a now-deleted post from a user named Altoid. "What an awesome thread," wrote Altoid. "You guys have a ton of great ideas. Has anyone seen Silk Road yet? It's kind of like an anonymous Amazon.com. I don't think they have heroin on there, but they are selling other stuff. They basically use Bitcoin and Tor to broker anonymous transactions." Alford searched for Altoid's post. The same user had posted in October 2011 that he was seeking the best and brightest IT pro in the Bitcoin community to be the lead developer in a venture-backed Bitcoin startup company. The recruitment post suggested sending an email to rossulbricht@gmail.com. Alford was only on the stand for about 90 minutes. The jurors were released at noon due to the impending blizzard in New York. The trial is set to continue on Thursday. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports, travel bans and early school closings were announced Monday as the Northeast prepared for a coastal storm bringing blizzard-like conditions. While much of the area got some combination of rain, snow, freezing rain, and sleet, conditions are expected to get dramatically worse. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo announced all trains and buses will be shut down and all driving will be banned in 13 affected counties. The travel ban began at 11 p.m. Monday night. At a press conference Monday afternoon, Cuomo said, "This is a serious situation. If you violate this state order, it's a possible misdemeanor. It's fine, up to $300. Additionally, flights are being canceled nationwide because of the impending storm. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Crammed into tiny bar stools, cramped diner booths, and filthy cars where moving their limbs is either uncomfortable or impossible, hundreds of thousands of consumers rip apart chicken wings or tear off bites of heroes and hamburgers every single day, often to the point of bloating, belching, and outright physical pain. Barbecue sauce or hamburger juice will literally dribble down these poor beasts' mouths and onto their shirts, their beards thick with pungent grease. Treated as little more than machines to be stuffed full of smoked pork, marinated chicken, and dry-aged beef, consumers are forced to wait in long lines, often while still fully conscious, before buying their meat and ripping it off the bone with their mouths in plain view of other consumers. The majority of meat consumers are often prodded to ingest vastly more than their bodies can handle thanks to cruel promotions like 25-cent wing nights and family-sized buckets of chicken. Help stop the brutality by visiting...
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. With you tonight in the studio, it's me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And Vice.com reporting on the Silk Road trial. This is actually from the first week of the trial, but we never shared this story. And since we were talking about juries, it seemed like an appropriate time to do so. That the judge has some concerns. Now, I'm certainly no fan of this judge. She has been very unfriendly towards the defense in the Ross Ulbricht case. Of course, Ross Ulbricht is the man accused of running the Silk Road, which is the underground drug marketplace that gathered so much infamy in the news media and in politics back in 2011, 2012, 2013, until it was taken down in October of 2013 and Ross Ulbricht arrested and charged with multiple felony counts that could land him in prison for maybe the rest of his life if he gets convicted of all of the counts, including the so-called kingpin charge. He's 30 years old and has been in court for the last few weeks. This is week number three of the trial. The first day of the trial, the judge had a concern that the jury doesn't really understand the ideas being explained, these basic internet concepts. She called the prosecution's explanation of Tor, which is the anonymizing system, one of the anonymizing systems for the internet, she called it mumbo jumbo, and she was concerned with the juror's knowledge. And obviously there's a knowledge gap between an average juror or what a judge can be expected to already know and the intricacies of modern cybercrime, which is, of course, true of any legal case. As a lawyer and as a judge, you have to become an expert in whatever each case happens to be about, according to the staff attorney for the Electronic Frontier Foundation. That said, it is definitely harder, especially for judges in an older generation who didn't grow up with computers, who didn't grow up with the internet, to understand things like Tor. Even a millennial who has taken computer science courses won't necessarily understand Tor on first explanation.
Oh yeah, Tor is complicated.
It's not unexpected, then, that the prosecution in this case would be so careful to make sure the jury understood the terms being used. Many of the jurors might not have ever heard of Silk Road until the trial began. So how do lawyers bridge that gap without having to give a master class on the deepest reaches of the web?
Well, wouldn't you not want jurors to know about, according to their sort of rules, wouldn't you not want them to know about Silk Road?
As a prosecutor, you mean?
Well, as a,
Oh, it's according to the court rules, yes.
Aren't they corrupted at that point?
Correct, yeah. In theory, the best juror would be someone who's never heard of the Silk Road, never heard of Ross Ulbricht.
And is smart.
True, but it wouldn't necessarily be somebody who is ignorant of Tor or general concepts of computer science.
That is true.
Although that sort of person usually doesn't get chosen. Prosecutors do tend to like people who are a little more blue collar, maybe more easily led.
Absolutely. Yeah,
I think that in a lot of ways, when you're looking sort of group dynamics, you'll find in groups that it's not the opinion of everybody that matters. It's the opinion of one or two or three people in a jury that's really going to matter, because those people are going to be able to make the case in the jury room as to what they believe, and they're going to make it eloquently, and they're going to make it passionately, and then the rest of the people are going to fall in line.
Because they want to go home.
Well, they're motivated to get the heck out of there. Okay, have we all come to a consensus? I guess I don't want to be the one standing in the way of this. And off
they
go.
Yeah, there's a lot of social pressure that goes along with that.
And also, I mean, there was a time in U.S. history when people were found not guilty a lot more often. And now they just, I think it's the cop shows, honestly, because the cops, oh yeah, they always get the right person there on trial. And juries also, they want a story that, they want another perpetrator. If we don't have the perpetrator here, then who is it? Defense attorney. And so that's why the defense attorney here decided to point at Mark Karpeles. And he probably will point at a few more before it's over.
Mark Karpeles is known for being the operator of MT Gox, which was the most popular Bitcoin exchange for a period of time until it went under, and he has been alleged to have stolen people's money in that situation. So that was kind of an interesting twist to the Silk Road case. So it's not unexpected that the prosecution, what's going on here? The lawyers have to explain the technology so the jury can get it, and it's up to the adversaries to make clear what's important for them to know. This according to a law professor at the George Washington University. They don't need to know everything. If a technical detail isn't pertinent to the argument, there's no need to labor it with the jury, he said. In that way, even the most complicated cybercrimes aren't any different from a more mundane case. He said, I really don't think it's that different. All of the jurors will have used the internet, and you just explain by analogy. They all use email and surf the web, and you build from that to more technical points. It's not easy, but in working with a jury, it's a common dynamic. But this knowledge gap can open the door to dicey legal arguments. Last year, Kerr helped successfully appeal a case against Andrew Weave Arnheimer, an internet troll sent to jail after he was accused of violating the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. Arnheimer had gained access to private email addresses after taking advantage of a security loophole that he found on AT&T's website. During the appeal process, the prosecution's argument pivoted largely on not explaining the technological aspects of his actions. Quote, he had to download the entire iOS system on his computer. He had to decrypt it. He had to do all of these things I don't even understand, Assistant U.S. Attorney Glenn Marco argued. The Third District ultimately granted Weave's appeal on the basis of an improper venue, but it didn't weigh in on the legality of his actions. Cardozo pointed out this knowledge gap can also be exploited by lawyers to bolster their arguments. Quote, we saw the prosecutor's opening statement in Ulbricht's case talk a lot about the dark web and use terminology like that. Tor is a U.S. Navy project. This isn't something that's come out of the underbelly of society. Of course, you could also argue.
You could argue it did.
Well, you could also say that if it didn't come out of the underbelly, even if you love the Navy or whatever, it's certainly home to a lot of really disturbing stuff.
Tor is something that people around the world use every day for very innocent purposes, Cardozo told me. The Silk Road may not have been one of those innocent purposes, but to cast aspersions on the dark web as something terrible shows that the prosecutor may be trying to exploit that lack of understanding. And this lack of understanding wreaks havoc, says Vice, at the Supreme Court as well. Last year, SCOTUS ruled that Aereo, a digital video startup, was in violation of the copyrights of the country's biggest broadcasters. But before the justices could deliberate, they had to spend a great deal of time trying to understand what in Sam Hill Aereo even was. Yeah. And SCOTUS is currently deliberating on whether or not death threats made on Facebook are illegal, despite the fact that most of the judges don't actually use the website themselves.
They don't have Facebook accounts.
These are old people. I mean, that's not to say that.
And they're probably not motivated. You know, they're motivated in the opposite direction, right? Like, they don't want to be involved on that because people, you know, be trying to contact them that way.
Send them a message.
Well, and they're probably not people with a lot of time to kill. You know, a lot of us go on Facebook because we're bored. I don't think your average Supreme Court justice spends a lot of time sitting around trying to figure out what to do with his time.
I think a lot of busy people have Facebook accounts.
Yeah. The good news is that SCOTUS takes a long time and asks a lot of seemingly silly questions to make sure they understand an issue before throwing down a verdict. And in lower courts, we've seen expert witnesses who are called upon to give their objective opinion and enlighten the courtroom on a given topic, meaning we don't need to rely on lawyers to provide all of the information in a case. Still, as hacking and cybercrime becomes more prolific and lawmakers pretty much the same thing, aim to create far-reaching blanket cybersecurity laws, these situations will become more and more common. As we move into the next frontier of tracking and criminalizing our online activity, the tension between the courtroom and techno-literacy will only increase. So it's interesting, some examples of how this has been a hurdle for attorneys to cross, and not only that, something that can be used as sort of a bludgeon against the jury in a way, like, you know, purposefully obscuring information by the prosecutor to keep a jury ignorant and to therefore possibly, you know, make the verdict go in the way they want. So some disturbing stuff there.
Mm.
Share your thoughts here with us. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Coming up, Mark, you've got some shocking news out of New Orleans, and Rich Paul, as a vaporizer user, this might interest you. If you are a nicotine user and you use the vaporizers, the e-cigarettes, you might want to stay away from New Orleans, from what I've understood about what you've told me, Mark. We'll find out more here in moments. There's terrible news coming up. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, January 19th, 2015, gold opened at $1,276.40. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,322.93, $661.47 for a half ounce, or $330.73 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,258.35, $661.47, and $330.73.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you right there. That's freetalklive.com. By the way, if you would like to get some gold and silver, just go to gold.freetalklive.com and you can grab up as much as you want. Also, they have unusual precious metals too, the, you know, not so gold and silver stuff. You can call them to find out about those options. 877-857-9938. It's Midas Resources, and they've been doing this for a long time, and they will hook you up. 877-857-9938 for gold and silver. Also, order online through silver.freetalklive.com or gold.freetalklive.com. Either one will take you there. And when you do that, you are helping Free Talk Live, because every purchase made over at Midas Resources through silver.freetalklive.com ultimately does benefit Free Talk Live. Some of it, a very small portion, will go to Free Talk Live.
Yeah, we get a little percentage.
Very small. And then another portion goes to benefit Midas Resources, which
plus
owns,
when they sell gold, they just like us more.
Which owns Genesis Communications Network, which is the company that helps us get on over 150 great radio stations from coast to coast. So, Mark, you've got a story tonight about smoking bans. They're expanding in New Orleans. And what's the latest? And where's it coming from?
It's coming from freebeacon.com. And it says right here, New Orleans bans smoking pretty much everywhere. It says bars, casinos, private clubs, parks, construction sites. New Orleans passed a far-reaching smoking ban on Thursday that prohibits lighting up in bars. And
private, wow, it's taken them this long.
Yeah, and private clubs, even in the car, while waiting in line at a drive-thru.
Oh, my gosh. So they just went all out at once.
Yeah, they did the whole thing.
A lot of this has been going on for years. I mean, when it was our first show back in 2002 when Free Talk Live came on the air, we were talking about Florida's smoking ban at that time that they were considering, and that's kind of one of the earlier ones.
And New Orleans is including e-cigs in this?
That's let me get to it here. Claiming that there's no constitutional right to smoke. The New Orleans City Council unanimously voted to outlaw smoking and electronic cigarettes indoor and outdoor.
Wow.
In indoor and outdoor public places. Now, an amendment has changed this to not affect, so it doesn't affect parks or outdoor shopping malls. So, what I would call a plaza.
Sidewalks? Not, I mean, that's a public place,
yeah,
right?
Well, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, with my understanding is, smoking and vaping, which has nothing to do with smoking except for the fact that you're inhaling something.
It's full on crazy to include e-cigarettes in these bans. I mean, it's just not the same thing.
Well, this is okay. So that's another issue. But just so I can understand this, so in a car, in any public place except for a park, and what was the other thing? Park and
private clubs, casinos, bars.
Private clubs.
No,
I was going through things that are
outdoor plazas.
Where can you smoke? Okay, outdoor plaza. Public park.
Yeah.
Inside your own home?
You can smoke inside your own home.
But not in any private business.
Right. It's your private property, not like a private business open to the public.
Okay. So this is an almost total smoking ban.
Yep. It's just about it. The ordinance, which goes into effect in 90 days, applies to bars, casinos, private clubs, any business establishment, recreational areas, sports arenas, theaters, and a host of other places. There's no legal or constitutional right to smoke, the ordinance said. Business owners have no legal or constitutional right to expose their employees and customers to the toxic chemicals and secondhand smoke.
That's actually what the ordinance says? It's not some supporter of it, not the mayor or a city council person?
That's what the ordinance said.
Wow.
On the contrary, employers have a common law duty to provide their workers with a workplace that is not unreasonably dangerous. That's why we're going to ban e-cigarettes, which are significantly less dangerous than cigarettes.
There's no evidence whatsoever. I mean, the evidence that secondhand smoke is dangerous is flimsy at best, and there's no evidence whatsoever that secondhand vapor does anything.
Yeah, I would say that, like, if you're – the secondhand smoke that would worry me is if I worked in a bar, right?
Mm-hmm.
But – that's a choice that one makes.
You can choose to not work in a bar.
One chooses every single day to go to work in that bar. That's a decision you make, and I think that that's something that's, you know, there should be a place for smokers to go and drink. The sort of you walk by somebody and it stinks, maybe you've got asthma or something like that, but, you know, walking down the road and smelling exhaust fumes mm-hmm. has got to be just as bad for you in
most
circumstances.
Don't give them any ideas. They'll try to ban that next.
Well, we'll see.
Probably not. The automotive lobby is obviously pretty heavy, but they certainly have put in mandated thingies under the hoods of cars to try to.
I think you
deal
can smoke
and
on.
Gore proposed eliminating cars from a lot of the major cities.
It does say here, maybe you can smoke on sidewalks, Ian. It says here, smoking will be banned within 25 feet of parks and bus stops. And remember, parks was removed mm-hmm. after on the amendment. So within 25 feet of bus stops.
Ah.
So maybe.
Which there are probably quite a few. I don't know how they define bus stop, but, you know, I'm from Sarasota, Florida, and there's bus stops everywhere down there, and it's not even a big city like New Orleans.
I doubt they're going to be passing out tickets for that, though, because 25 feet isn't very far. Right, so
why would you doubt they'll pass out tickets?
Because the cop has to go step out 25 feet from the bus stop. And where is the bus stop exactly? Bus stop isn't going to be painted on the sidewalk.
There's usually little signs.
Yes, but I understand. You know, how big is the bus stop area, Ian? Are you talking about just the overhang? Are you talking about the sign? In many mm-hmm. cases down south, there's just a sign. Is there
That's
a painted on area on the sidewalk? Is that what you saw in Sarasota, Florida? Because
no,
I never saw it. Yeah.
No, I would expect that it would go about 25 feet from
25
the sign.
25 radial feet from the sign. So, I mean, if you happen to be 24 feet, you're within it, you're 25.
If you're walking down the sidewalk smoking a cigarette, you're going to walk through multiple bus stops.
You could.
Or at least the 25-foot range outside of that bus stop.
I think that'll be sort of like... it'll happen so rarely that they pass out a ticket for that activity that it would be nearly still legal. Just because it would still be so difficult to enforce.
I think that's going to be right at first because you'd get a lot of resistance back when you pass those, when you wrote those tickets. But a lot of times they'll pass a law, but they won't fully enforce it at first because they don't want all the public backlash
That's
to come at the same time.
Yeah, it's more likely.
So they'll phase in enforcement.
Yeah,
when
I
people are
right.
a little bit more sheepish, they'll start getting them by the bus stop.
And when they're not paying as much attention. Because like you're saying, if they are to just all of a sudden start a crackdown the day after this thing goes into effect, then it'll be pretty apparent that this is an outrageous infringement upon people's rights. But if they wait a year or wait 6 months and then they start trickling in arrests, well, then there won't be as much outrage. There won't be as much likelihood of news coverage. It'll just be they're writing tickets and people are paying them. Because hardly anyone's going to take it to court.
Businesses can have their permits suspended if they allow smoking on premises. Mm. This is why they give you a business license
in the
first place. So they can take it away. New Orleans residents will also no longer be able to smoke in their cars while waiting to use an ATM.
Wait, they can't smoke in their cars at any time or only when they're waiting for an ATM?
It just says while waiting to use an ATM. I didn't make that
now,
up.
Now, what about drive-thrus? Because that's another thing I saw mentioned with respect to this.
Drive-thrus?
That's banned.
Yep.
All right, stand by. Well, there's more to the story.
Yeah.
We'll come back with it. I'm wondering what the vote was. I don't know if it's got that information, if it was unanimous or if there were even any dissenters on the city council. 855-450-FREE.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Superbeta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Superbeta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090. Call 1-800-467-5090.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media newsfeed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com, advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Well, you knew the smoking bans could get worse. Over time, we've seen how these various different bans in parts of the country. California has been one of the worst places of all the 50 states, and certain cities within California even worse than the state of California, like the one city, I forget which one it is, that has banned the act of smoking in any house that is connected to another living unit. So a duplex, a triplex, an apartment building, anything like that, smoking banned in that particular town. I'm sorry, I don't remember which one it is, but it's somewhere in California, so stay out of California if you care about your
freedom
to smoke.
In all likelihood, it begins with San.
I don't know. But anyway, the story here is pretty disturbing because this is the first time I've heard of, at least in recent that I can recall, and maybe you can correct me on this, is this the first vaping ban that has been enacted in the United States?
Major vaping ban, I would say.
Because I don't recall hearing of another one. I mean, I know that in the courthouse here in Cheshire County, they've banned vaporizers from the courthouse. But as far as like a sweeping no vaping in certain locations bill being passed, this is the first one I recall hearing about. Now, if you know of another one, please give us a call toll free and give us a heads up. The toll free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Mark, you've got more from the, freebeacon.com?
Yeah.
On this smoking ban that affects not just cigarette smokers, but vapors, people using e-cigarettes, which is a completely different process, completely different thing than smoking. It's much better for you from what I can tell. It smells a lot better to be around it. If you're a certain number of feet away, you're not even going to be able to smell the person using the vaporizer.
Sometimes Cantwell will have his
vapor. Well, you might smell the person, but you won't smell the vapor.
Very unlikely you'll smell the vapor, unless you're within 6 feet of the person.
Yeah.
There has been an exception to this. So normally I would say that vaporizers, you can't smell 6 feet away from the person.
Yeah.
And I think that's true. Generally. But if there's a whole bar full of people that are vaping, then you will smell it. There was at the local bar that we meet at on Sundays here for Social Sundays in Keene, New Hampshire. It's kind of an activist meetup where we just hang out and socialize. There was one time when they did have the New England Vapers. They had like a club of vaporizer users. And so there were enough people in the bar to where the vapor scent was wafting to some extent. You could smell it if you were elsewhere. If you weren't hanging out with the vapor group, you could still smell the vaping that was going on. But it's not unpleasant. I mean, unless you find fruity scents to be unpleasant, then you shouldn't be bothered by people vaping.
There's a residual amount of nicotine in it. Now, there's less nicotine in generally in vapor than the vaporizer vapor than there is in cigarette smoke by a good percentage. Cigarette smoke is much stronger. It provides sort of a hit of nicotine as opposed to sort of a dribble as vaporizers do. This is one of the reasons vaporizer users will just kind of keep on doing it all day long. You know, they're keeping up their, you know, nicotine as it goes on. It's much more like a patch than it is like a cigarette, a nicotine patch. So you're getting a residual amount of nicotine, and nicotine's certainly a poison, but it's, you remember, poison's in the dose.
Yeah, tomatoes have nicotine in them.
They do. Absolutely. Every tomato you eat, you're ingesting nicotine. So, and when you have water, there's probably some strychnine in it. Arsenic? Right. I can't remember which one it is. One of those things relatively regularly found in water. And, you know, that's a poison. Full on.
Probably arsenic, because arsenic is an element.
There you go.
Yeah. So let's go on here with the story, Mark. They're banning it from... Can you recap briefly for our listeners just tuning in?
Yeah. Basically, almost every... quite a bit outdoors and everything indoors as far as vaporizers and cigarettes go. Smoking is now banned in all outdoor service lines, including lines in which service is obtained by persons in vehicles.
So a drive-through, for instance, if you're waiting at the McDonald's and you're smoking in your car, that's illegal now.
Bank tellers, parking lot attendants, and toll takers. In which service is obtained by persons in vehicles, smoking is prohibited by both pedestrians and persons in vehicles, but only within 25 feet of the point of service, says the
so
ordinance.
You can smoke. What is the point of service? Would that be where the food is passed through the drive-thru window?
If there's two windows, I think that's two points of service.
But also, isn't it a point of service at which you order?
I don't think so.
Aren't you being served if someone is taking your order?
Or is it only
when you're being given the food? It'll all be up to interpretation by the officers on hand and then the courts.
As an attorney, I would say that they can only consider one point of, or if I was arguing this as an attorney, I would argue that they can only consider one point to be the point of service because it says the point of service. Not
in many cases, when you're looking at those two windows, drive-thrus, like say
McDonald's has those,
something like that, that's about 25 feet away. Mm-hmm. I mean, from each other, so you could like smoke at the one and not the other if that's what you wanted
to do. It's crazy. This is just crazy.
In lines which service, according to the ordinance, smoking is only allowed in private homes, private residences. There's a difference between a private home and a residence. Private vehicles, but even they have
a public residence would be one run by the welfare department.
But what's a home and what's a residence? A home's not a residence. A residence not a home. What the hell is this?
Yeah, this is legal land.
But if they have restrictions, if they're used for childcare, So you can do it in your house and you can do it in your car, but I don't know what this use for child care means. Does that mean that you have a child, or does that mean that you have other people's children? Yeah,
right. I suspect it would be other people's children.
Well, you're just trying to be reasonable. These people are banning smoking everywhere. You know, like, Rich, I think we got to step out of reason.
All right, so what else do we need to know about this?
Smoking rooms and hotels will still be allowed, and in retail tobacco stores. However, tobacco retailers will not be allowed to sell products within 300 feet of any park, church, public library, school, or any other child care facility. E-cigarettes are included in the ban because their use in public creates a concern and confusion and leads to difficulties in enforcing the smoking prohibitions. Mm. It has nothing to do with public health. It has everything to do with, that looks like it might be cigarettes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, let's go to Sid. He's in Charleston, West Virginia, listening to WVTS. Sid, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, and Mark.
Yes, sir. They said it wasn't a constitutional right to smoke, but I believe in the preamble it says you have the right to pursue happiness. And I don't know about you, but smoking and vaping make me happy.
Yeah, I think the pursuit of happiness is in the Declaration of Independence, which is a rhetorical document. Preamble includes that's that where they get the general welfare clause and that sort of stuff.
Yeah, it's true, but
still crazy.
But you can interpret when the Ninth Amendment says that the enumeration in certain rights in the Constitution should not be held to deny or disparage others retained by the people. The question becomes, what are those? Well, a reasonable stand-in for the rights, the common law rights of the people, are life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. So I think that at least gives you an idea of what the Founding Fathers were thinking when they wrote the Ninth Amendment.
Of course, pretty much everything the government does infringes upon your right to pursue happiness. And so, you know, here we are, where now they're telling you you can't even use a vaporizing device. So, Sid, in Charleston, you've got a situation where there are bars that are prohibited from having smoking. So are you familiar with how difficult is it to smoke there in Charleston?
Well, in the streets, it's frowned upon, but not quite illegal. In the bars, in certain counties in the state, it's illegal, but one of the bars that I favor is one of the few that still allows it because it's a private establishment.
Which bar is that?
That's Easy Street over in St. Albans.
You say it's private, so does that mean that you have to join like a club membership to get in there?
No, it's just privately owned. It's not
almost all bars are privately owned.
A lot of the ones around here are more corporate bars.
Okay, so you're saying that the law makes a differentiation between a bar that's owned by a corporation versus an individual?
No, it's more the corporate bars follow the laws of the state that they're based in. So if they're based out in California and California says bars can't smoke, they just make it nationwide on all their bars you can't smoke in them.
Mm.
But my first job got shut down because we allowed smoking inside. We were in a county that allowed smoking. Then they changed the rule. We had all the stuff.
We'll come back with more here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The United States Constitution was written to secure the promise of the Declaration of Independence. In 1776, our founding fathers declared that individuals have certain inalienable rights, rights that cannot be taken away. Everyone in this nation has the right to live and is free to pursue happiness and liberty so long as they respect the rights of others. We created government to protect this freedom, not to give us special favors at the expense of others, and so our federal government exists to protect individual freedoms. That's why the first sentence of the Constitution, written in 1787, says that liberty is a blessing, even as it goes on to strictly limit what decisions government may make for us. America's founding fathers knew that protecting individual rights, our personal freedom, is the main purpose of government. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Worried about getting sick and feeling terrible for days or even weeks? You need Immudyne for a healthy immune system. Why get sick and bother with products that just don't work? For just $1 a day, Immudyne is all natural and safe for all lifestyles. Call 866-257-8668 to buy now before it's too late, before you get sick. Or go to immudyne.com, immudyne.com, or call 866-257-8668.
Genesis is defined as an origin, creation, or the beginning. Genesis Communications Network began with the mission of providing you with the kind of compelling content you're listening to now. And at GCNlive.com, you'll find a free archive of our nation's history, narrated by GCN hosts, explored, shared, and passed down to future generations. GCN is the future of talk radio. We should always strive to learn from our past. Together, we are GCNlive.com. GCN.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain here, but enough time for you with your call and thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Smoking just got banned in New Orleans. A 7-0 vote. I don't know if the other story mentioned that. This was unanimous by the city council in New Orleans to ban smoking and vaporizing. I think that's the most noteworthy part because we've seen a zillion smoking bans. Not that that makes any of them okay, but they're certainly, you know, typical at this point. But what is atypical here is that the vaporizing is also banned. And the city bureaucrats admit that it wasn't because they consider vaporizing to be dangerous necessarily, but simply because having vaporizers being allowed in a place where smoking has been banned, they say, would make enforcement difficult. And so in order to make enforcement easier, they had just gone ahead and just banned anything that emits a cloud from your mouth.
Yeah.
Bill Clinton loved making war on smokers, and in a way, I'm glad that he did, because it was when it was some of Bill Clinton's attacks on smokers that caused me to go out looking for a political party that supported smokers' rights.
Oh, really?
And that's a big part of how I ended up in the Libertarian Party. I remember I was just barely over the line on the Nolan chart into Libertarian territory because I was still pretty much socialist on economics, but I was so pissed off about the smoking thing that I said, okay, I'm a libertarian now. I remember saying to myself, I'll just vote libertarian until I'm a little bit too free. And haven't gotten there yet.
Yeah, it hasn't worked. Let's go to John. He's in West Virginia. John, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just wanted to clear up the confusion by that last caller. The reason that bar that he goes to can allow smoking and other bars in the area can't is that bar is in Putnam County. Which is just on the edge of Kanawha County, which is where Charleston is.
Gotcha.
And
that'll make all the difference in the world.
Yeah, he seemed to think there was some sort of differentiation between a private corporation or a private. I didn't really understand what he was saying.
Right. It was just confusing as all get out. Kanawha County, the health board, passed the law banning smoking in all eating and, all restaurants and bars. And
thus sending all the smoking business to this one bar that's just on the edge of town.
Well, except it's a bit sketchy, and I don't know that. I mean, I've been there a couple of times, and I personally prefer being able to go out to a bar and not come home and smell like an ashtray.
Right. Well, so it's a preference for you not to go. Look, I feel the same way. I'm not a cigarette smoker, and I like it better now that they've banned smoking here in New Hampshire. But I will constantly advocate for the right of a business owner to decide what people do in their business. I think it's the business owner's decision, and that's really the issue here. There were non-smoking bars in the where I live, in the city of Keene.
Were they?
Yeah, but there was Applebee's and Chili's and places like that. You know, they didn't want.
That's a good point.
And there would have been Chili's. A lot more of them if the smoking area laws had not been what they were. It used to be that they required that every restaurant held aside, say, 50 or 70% of their floor space for a non-smoking area. Mm-hmm. And that was unfortunate because it spread the smokers somewhat. So you couldn't have a totally non-smoking bar and then next door have a totally smoking bar.
I see what you're saying.
Because you wouldn't have enough floor space, and that was unfortunate. If it had been deregulated, I think whole businesses would have been smoking or non-smoking.
Yeah, the market
would
solve
the
problem. John, anything else you want to share tonight?
Nope, just wanted to clear that up.
Good call. Thanks for doing that. I appreciate it because I was pretty confused, and it was toward the end of the segment, so we really didn't have time to nail it down. Michael's in Albuquerque listening to Kiva. Hello, Michael.
Well, hello. How are you guys doing tonight?
Good, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I quit smoking. It's easy. Every time I put one out, I quit.
You have that sound.
I'm getting up there in years. But in any event, we have a situation here in Albuquerque that's unusual, I believe. But I've seen it in San Diego. You don't smoke on buses. And you don't smoke, around the bus stop. But they do. See, they leave their buses on, the big diesel buses.
Yep.
If you're concerned about pollution, I mean, you don't need to smoke a cigarette to die. I mean, it's really bad. Although they do say they want you to go 100 feet away, but they don't make a big deal out of it. And the reason is not because of the vapors. It's because of the possible explosion from the gases coming out the buses that they leave on all the time it's on its route.
You're saying gas is coming out of the buses in Albuquerque?
Yeah, well, the gas is from the mufflers, that gas, that chemical.
Could it explode?
I don't know if it could or not. But I haven't read the story of a bus exploding as a result of somebody smoking a cigarette.
But that's their logic. But the thing is, a cigarette's not going to hurt you anywhere near as bad as just sitting there at that bus stop.
I get your point there. The buses are very stinky. Right. There's no doubt about that.
Are they going to ticket the bus driver?
No, because they work for the government in most places. Michael, thanks for the call tonight. Danny's in West Virginia listening to WVTS. Hello, Danny.
Hey, I don't know what it is about West Virginia tonight, but
we are live in Charleston. That's what it is. And
I know that part, but apparently West Virginia is apparently getting really into this, but I actually live in the Kanawha and Putnam County area as well. But just to make it quick, so I know you guys are in the hour, but one of the things that was actually used as a vice for smoking was a percentage of are you a bar and are you a restaurant. I managed bars and restaurants. I was a smoker. I quit. And however, the bar and restaurant industry was forced to make a decision, and they did it on a how much food do you serve and how much alcohol do you serve, and that's how they were able to make the decisions of, well, you're allowed to smoke and you're not allowed to smoke. And it was just a huge infringement on so many businesses in this area over the last 5 years based on the simple fact of you are or you aren't allowed to make a decision for what you want to do for your business based on how much money did you make last month, last year, last quarter, based on alcohol or food. And
food
they
sales.
Got to make the decision of what you do.
Yeah. So did they know this was coming, or was this just sort of a surprise? They'd open up your books, let's take a look, see how much food you sold.
It was kind of one of those things that you had a lot of coverage of smoking is bad and we need to stop it. What do you want to do? And it was very, very vague. Now, yep. On the business side of it, it was known that it was coming, and a lot of restaurants and bars, I've done some consulting and stuff, had to make the decision of, all right, the rule was, I believe it was at the beginning of the law, was 80% alcohol, 20% food. And so what we did was we had a cutoff, was once we hit a dollar amount, we weren't allowed to sell any more food.
Because if you went over that amount, then you would have smoking would have been banned at that time.
Correct. Smoking would have been banned. It wasn't a matter of do you want to smoke in our bar or not smoke in our bar, which would have been completely acceptable because once I quit smoking, still working in the bar industry, smoking, I didn't like it. I came home, I smelled, my clothes smelled, and all that other stuff. Like, do you hear from anybody else that doesn't smoke, whether they did or didn't? But there was no option. It was, all right, well, at this point, we can't serve food anymore. And it was actually a common knowledge of patrons. Well, that's because of the 80-20 rule. And then it became the 85-15 rule. And then it became, well, with a county by county, they just eliminated that. And they said, all right, well, in Kanawha County, you're not allowed to smoke within 25 feet of anything.
Period.
At all.
Okay.
Danny, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate the inside info. By the way, a little bit more here about New Orleans. This from NOLA.com. They say that the enforcement of the ban has been left to city agencies, including the Departments of Health, Code Enforcement, Recreation, Parks, and Parkways and Safety and Permits. So it sounds to me like there's quite a few people that can write a ticket in the city of New Orleans. This isn't just a police-enforced ordinance. This will be enforced by multiple departments. Lawmakers and staff said privately that the law is likely to be self-regulating, meaning that anyone can call 311 to complain about a bar allowing smoking or vaping. Yes, that's right. You'll be encouraged to snitch on your neighbors and
there was just
owners.
A lady, I read a story this week about a lady who called 311 too often to snitch.
Really? In New Orleans?
No, it wasn't in New Orleans. It's, this is pretty
that
common.
That was New York, wasn't it? The woman who got arrested for calling about drug dealers?
Yes.
I thought, wow, that's such karma to have the pigs come down on an inveterate rat. That's just, wow.
The new law doesn't demand employees in bars and restaurants be forced to order patrons to stop smoking or vaping, but it does require their manager or the bar's owner to do so. So essentially every owner, every manager, has become an enforcement agent for this new law. This is just insane. And we're out of time for tonight. But you can join us online between now and tomorrow at freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Peace News Now is next after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, January 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.96 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,284 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $265. Antiwar.com reports from Kurdish officials say that after 112 days of fighting, they have finally expelled the Islamic State from the contested border city of Kobani, and that their YPG militias are now fully in control. YPG officials confirmed the takeover, and the city's deputy foreign minister said there will be an official announcement of victory on Tuesday. The Islamic State has launched several offensives against Kobani and so far failed to take the city, the last major Kurdish holding to their west. The final death toll of the latest battle was 979 the Islamic State fighters and 324 YPG fighters. Kobani's value to the Islamic State is twofold, as it is both a border crossing into Turkey and would give the Islamic State contiguous control over a vast span of the border and increasingly near the city of Aleppo. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or